Takiro.
Radiant Team Pick. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Behold the Horn of Madness.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Prepare for battle. Seconds to battle.
Perfect.
First blood, my steed.
First blood. It was ours all along.
The battle begins.
Denied.
On if the nightmare is put onto the Abaddon. And apologies to those watching in game, the mic is back on. Sorry you missed out on the draft. It was a pretty quick one anyways. But AUI in some trouble right now in the bottom lane. Jakiro, he's gonna go down, making it 1-1 right now, putting VP Polar on the board. Can they get another one? Bone 7, only level 1, doesn't have leap, couldn't do it either way. 3 mana to his name right now, and taking a lot of damage on the way out of here. Aggressive tri lane is running out of fuel.
If the clarity had been popped by a little just a moment sooner, like let's say 2 or 3 seconds sooner, then they actually could have followed up with another magic missile. No, again, no leap to disjoint it, so that should have been a kill, but Lil was very hesitant on what or not he wanted to do it, and then he pops it and immediately loses it. So kind of a hesitation moment for him. But in the end, we're just going to be seeing a 1-for-1 across the board. AM, though, very much more confident in this lane now because he has the Aphotic Shield behind him. He has a Poor Man's Shield, and he'll probably have 1 point in his passive spell shield. He's going to be able to just, through this triple shield strat, allow him to just be very aggressive, very active in his mana draining, and of course, just not eating arrows. Illil will dodge to the east.
Yeah, and well, double damage on Bane. He's out of mana, though. No Nightmare, so I don't think they're going to get too aggressive down there until they can at least start off with the Nightmare. We'll look over towards middle. Eternal Envy farming really, really well. He's 12-6, even getting good denies, although Mag 11-3 on one of his signature heroes here, the Magnus. And up top, it's Phobos versus Feyta. Phobos at 9-1, Feyta 8-1 on the Brewmaster and Venomancer, respectively. So both the mid and that offlane going very, very even. Even 2 kills apiece here in the tri-lanes that clash. Looking at the farm, Mirana 9, Anti-Mage 4. Cloud9 maybe with a very slight advantage down here, but all across the board, it's very even.
Yeah, very even. I would say that although Bone7 has more CS, he gets less value out of it per gold point compared to the Anti-Mage. So the Anti-Mage isn't terribly upset about the situation, but of course he would prefer to be getting a ton of farm. We do see on top lane that ZK Phobos will connect with a Clab, be met with a Gale, and only get 2, maybe 3 right clicks in as he finally turns about. But down bottom is kind of a dive here as they are looking for an opportunity. They have a lot of spells in their arsenal. They split them up. That's the big thing here is they get everybody split. A weird little loop from Bone7 though, and Illidan gets shielded up to keep dealing the damage. It's going to be Lil to go down first as, no, he gets healed. He's still alive, and Illidan's going to jump onto Bone7. They bring him down. Nobody has fallen on the side of VP Polar, and Aoi might fall as well. There is going to be a blink coming out in just 3 seconds time from Illidan, and he will look to finish off the twin-headed dragon. Magic stick not going to be enough to save him here. It's a double kill for Illidan. Won't be able to go for the third, but just the fact that I didn't lose any heroes in that, as the nice heal from FNG came out onto the Vengeful Spirit, puts him in a really good spot here, and the rune spawn will go to Abaddon as well.
Well, at least it wasn't a first blood double kill to the Anti-Mage, but still, a double kill to the Anti-Mage. He's not getting a lot of farm, but that really boosts him up. Just to check his net worth right now, 1600, the highest right now is 2k, so even with 5 last hits, he's pretty much up there in the top of the net worth charts here in the very, very early game, about 4 minutes. He'll get his ring of health right now, and with that, he can sustain this lane a little bit better. I think all the supports on both sides, some respawning, some running back to base to heal up, everyone was getting pretty low on mana down there. The only one to stay was Illidan, actually, as he did, again, get the Ring of Health. So we'll see if they can maybe try to have a go onto the Anti-Mage while the supports are gone, or if those supports will just rotate. We already see Polar, or Little, here going up to the top lane.
Yeah, so it's interesting that in this particular try versus try, magic sticks aren't as relevant as they usually are. Usually it's like whoever gets magic sticks first has the sustainability to win the skirmishes. But in this case, pretty much all of the spells you're using are at least 10 seconds on cooldown. So although still there's probably 2 spell casts per person, they're not completely spammed out. It's kind of varies whether or not it's going to be effective. We do see this magic missile flank coming onto Fata here. The plague wards will scout him out in a moment, but it's not going to prevent the stun from coming through and him from taking a lot of damage here. With the clap, he will be going down, just trying to trade his life for that of Lil, but he'll be able to TP away and the damage over time will not be enough. So it is going to be a nice little clean gank there, but in his absence, maybe they can make him play down bottom.
Yeah, they could have maybe got a kill if someone TP'd up top, but you can't really TP up top. Like, if Pylite Die goes up top, then it's Bone7 versus this Anti-Mage, and then Illidan just gets more than you want this Anti-Mage to get in the early game. He starts getting some farm on top of that double kill he just got. He's up to 10 lasted, so they're kind of locked in this aggressive tri lane a little bit. VP Polar, I think, less so. I mean, we already saw that rotation from Venge, and that nets a kill. It's 4-1 for VP Polar right now in the early game, but this Lycan is still farming really, really well. 34-7. It's getting quite a bit. He just spent all his money and doesn't have much of anything, so something must be on the courier, something big. It's a Medallion of Courage is going to be his first item completed and coming out.
Yeah. Now, I'm not sure if you mentioned this verbally, but of course, Aoi 2000 did what he often does, taking the mid lane in lieu of Eternal Envy. Eternal Envy rotates to the jungle. He does this on TB and Lycan in particular, and he does it very early on, around the 5-6 minute mark. So he's in the jungle. Aoi 2000 getting solo experience and is doing fine on this mid lane here. So he's going to be able to kind of go for a semi-core, as he definitely likes to play that kind of 3.5 position, I guess you could say.
Yeah, well, the good news is Jakiro is going to get some farm, maybe have a Yule Scepter for 20 minutes. The bad news is now it's just like a pure Bone 7 offlane. Maybe Pyloidai comes around eventually to help out, but Illidan's going to start getting a lot. And this tower might even fall. Bone 7 in some trouble, needs to use that leap. Can Little get in range? Oh, he can! He actually gets off that magic missile! And that's going to be a kill there. Wave of Terror going out. It's actually Little that gets it. He's 3-0-1. He's on a killing spree right now. The little Venge that could.
One creep kill, 3 hero kills. That's the priority system right there. But
why farm creeps when you can farm heroes?
It's very true. But now we have this build-up for the Anti-Mage here. He's finally going to get the free farm he's always wanted. And there's not really much the Marana can do to disrupt that. As you mentioned, the support rotation away pretty much gave that lane back to AM. They did delay his farm a little bit, but I wouldn't say that they completely inhibited it. Anyways, up top, DK Bubbles went for Tranquil Boots as a way to sustain against the Venomancer. But you got to remember, even if it's just a basic Plague Ward auto hits you, it will break the boots for that 13-second cooldown, so...
I guess the armor and Tranquils helps against the Plague Ward right-click, but I don't know.
Seems like Plague Ward do more magical
damage. Still seems like a weird choice to me.
Yeah, if you look at the Venomancer build, it's 1-3-3. The Plague Wards do more magical damage than physical.
Than physical, yeah.
Unless they're, like... I guess if you have, like, 5 consecutive auto-attacks and it keeps refreshing, then that doesn't really do the same math. But in other cases, it's piercing damage. It does 75% of the expected damage to heroes, but it does double that damage to creeps. Brewmaster actually being forced back here. Fata used his Gale, and we're going to have to see those Tranquil Boots do some work. He's going to be off the lane for a little bit.
Yeah, well, if he really wanted to, he could use the 7 Wand Charges to just get back into laning, but generally you want to save the heavy Wand Charges for, you know, getting someone to baiting them in for a kill, and then you heal up, or even just keeping them in case when you're actually in danger.
And using him for mana as well. He wants to be efficient in that capacity.
Mag standing ready to try to get the RP skewer. Skewer to RP either way. He's got the mana boots and 1400 gold as he looks towards that blink.
Abaddon should die here, I think, if they see him. But it's going to be the yellow coming back around. DK Phobos is going to catch an IE, and it's going to be the Shapeshift and Primal Split both going out.
Wow, they won't Warcraft needs around. Oh, not quite. They didn't quite get it. He's able to run out. Meanwhile, FNG, without the Nightmare, will take an arrow to the face. Pyloidai and Bone 7 going to get caught up in the RP. That was Mag. Now Little coming over. He's like, again, I'm not hitting creeps. Trying to get another hero kill up here. One more attack is actually the Shockwave from Magnus that'll do it. Give it the double kill to Mag. There's your Blink Dagger. He's got it in about 100 gold.
Very nice. Pyloidai down bottom is taking a couple of mana. Look, he just TP'd the lane. He has his two spells and he got right-clicked twice by Anti-Mage, and suddenly he's completely out of mana. Essentially a walking range creep. That's very unfortunate. But yeah, in that situation, essentially the Brewmaster ultimate was used to nullify the Lycan entirely. You can't do surrounds as easily on Lycanthrope because his hitbox is reduced, his collision size is reduced, so he's able to go through paths that most heroes normally aren't. But still, they used the tornado once or twice, and they were able to wait it out, force him into retreat, and it was just pretty much a 2v2 from there. They kill the Abaddon, obviously they kill the Bane and the Marana, and Magnus comes out pretty well ahead, as we do see now on the courier. The Blink Dagger has arrived.
That's really nice.
But still, the Venomancer has gotten some good farm up on the top lane. His net worth is only at 2600. Could be a bit better, but if they can combine Gale into Arrow, finding Gale on Brew would be different.
Seemed nice. Unnecessary for Mag on the Magnus, but why not? Skewering people up the terrain, he can blink off in a couple seconds. So he's got that blink, big core item for VP Polar. Looking for the other Blink Dagger is the Brewmaster, who's sitting at 1400
gold.
Oh,
big arrow, but do they have the DPS? He doesn't have a split to get out of this, and yeah, with the medallion and big right clicks from those maxed out wolves, they'll take the Brew, and I think they'll take this tower.
Oh, that was a big camera fail on my part. I was looking at Brew, I didn't see Marana, I looked for Marana, and then I missed all of it, so whatever. That's what a long day of staring at a screen does to you, I guess. But bringing down the tower as well, Venomancer helping with the push. He's got the maxed out Plague Wards right now. Mag is going to come to help, I guess, just stop the push. And that's a big kill on the Brewmaster. I was just pointing out he had 1,500 gold, and they'll take away about 300 of that. So trying to delay his Blink Dagger, because when you got the clap and the RP coming in, like blinking on top of you, Anti-Mage has a blink already. Like, it's going to be really hard to find those kills. Bane and Marana have been able to set up a few, but Bane 0 and 2, we look at Marana also dying 3 times, 3 and 3, so their hands are bloody on that cast, as you would normally expect, right?
Yeah,
Illidan, look how aggressive he's getting.
One more hit. It's going to be the Aphotic Shield. We'll bring him down. He went in, and I really think I got to question his judgment there. Like, he went and traded hits and then brain zapped him, and again, that leaves you with absolutely no mana on the lane. He's just going to keep diving you, and in this case, he went for an Enfeeble play, which was enough distance for Illidan to just jump on with the Aphotic. So, nice little kill there. Some good money going towards the Abaddon, and the Battle Fury remains uninhibited.
Yeah, it looks like Abaddon's going to be going towards the... He's got the Sage's Mask, so he'll probably be building up that urn eventually. Battle Fury, yeah, like you said, uninhibited on the Anti-Mage. Blink's there on the Magnus. We'll look at Brewmaster. He's got Tranquil Boots and the Wand still. Trying to get to the Blink Dagger, the next big item. And Little trying to complete some treads. We'll have to go to the top rune. I think, was that Lycan's voice picking up the haste?
No, Anti-Mage.
Anti-Mage.
But Bone 7 without a leap will be secured back into a Magic Missile here, and he will be going down.
At least he got the Bounty Rune.
Does get the Bounty Rune. We'll be able to pop that, you know, about 1301. But we do see down bottom that Fox is going to pop both of his spells onto the Anti-Mage here. The Aphotic Shield will take off the Gale if it even connected. And FNG is actually dropping very low with his ultimate here. The Sting, the Nova.
Oh, the block!
But it's all the more important for Illidan to get that kill. And indeed he did.
Yeah, Little here though, and Illidan, I don't know, he wants to go back in. Only one point of the spell shield right now, but you're also completely out of mana if you're Feta. He gets the Gale there. There's no damage, only the strike. Can the Plague Wards bring him down? Illidan's even going to lend his right clicks, and he will live. Ring of Health is going to be, just kidding, Pile die. Coming from the tree line, the assassination there. The Creature of Nightmares coming through. He's got the Fiend's Grip. First of the game as he hits level 6. Throws it on to Little dying very, very quickly, but Wands up. He won't go down. And now Mag coming in for Pile die, and even though Pile die dies, the fact that he had the drive-by on the Anti-Mage is definitely worth it here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and it's also distraction time. Like, although the play of going for the Venge nets them absolutely nothing as far as actual kills, it's space created for Eternal Envy to, with the double damage, the Medallion, bring down the Roche pre-Vlad. So it's actually really big. So they're going to be able to get the Aegis up on him. That'll be about the 13-minute Roche timer. We'll start those cycles, and starting those cycles early is really important for a Lycan Dire team in general, because it's not just getting Roche in the first place, it's how many Roches you get in the future, because it is kind of that renewable resource on a dedicated timer. So we'll see that he will be able to have the Aegis scout out with the wolves and get, of course, that big gold experience boon. Actually, Illidan just being harassed out of his own jungle with the medallion. The wolves doing some work there.
Mm-hmm. That was expensive space, though. That was a 2-for-4 trade. Cloud9 lost 4 heroes while Eternal Envy was busy in the hyperbolic time chamber that is the Roshan pit.
Nice.
He's working on it, man.
Bone 7 looking for an opportunity, but Pi doesn't have his Fiend's Grip just yet, so short-range arrows will not be getting them any opportunities here. Venge probably going for Medallion herself just for some good casual armor and maybe a chance to kill somebody off in the right situation. DK Phobos, as you mentioned, his blink was delayed, but it has now arrived. One issue is going to be mana, though. Magic Wand is good, but the lack of arcanes kind of sucks. Illidan taking some big hits here. The Medallion is no longer afflicting him, but he still is pretty low on HP and FNG. He's going to have to be forced to use Borrow Time.
Nice use of the illusions. Making the Borrow Time proc on itself.
Mm-hmm. Now a new
blink for Phobos. Moonlight Shadow went out, though. It's, half left? No, actually just ran out right there. So Phobos, they're going to spot him out. He can go ahead and clap if he wants. Maybe he claps. He doesn't have mana for the ult. There he does. He wands up. He'll find it for the ult. He wants to go on EE. Actually, they'll just cyclone him up and focus other people. FNG is going to go down. He will deny himself on that heal. Mag is now going to be Fiend's Gripped up. Good positioning by Pylite Guy. The swap goes through, but is it too late? Magnus and the Abaddon already down right now. Brewmaster still in his ult form. He's going to come out now. He's like full health as well. Not a lot of mana. He'll try to blink away. Venge to fall. Feta, the only casualty right now on Cloud9. VP Polar have lost 3. Phobos trying to get back to his side of the map. Arrow. No, not an arrow. That was a noise from Lycan. My sound, I can't even hear today, apparently. But Phobos able to get out and escape. Courier, that must be what they're going for. Cardi, and a little bit of trouble.
That would have been really disastrous if they mismicroed that right into everyone. But, yeah, he makes his way out. He survives. He'll live to see another day. In the meantime, this jungle is now essentially Cloud9's. Like, they still have the Aegis. They're actually going in for a stun combo. DK Phobos doesn't have an ulti, but they will wake him up from the nightmare, only for him to eat an arrow. Disengage is real. We see up top Illidan forced back by the Venomancer. Still doesn't have that Battle Fury just yet, and he really needs to just step on the farm. Like, he was on a trajectory for a really well-timed Battle Fury despite the aggressive tri lane, but because these last couple of fights haven't been 100% positive for him. He'd rather just be farming, and they seem to be doing a pretty good job of keeping him out of the jungle and off the lane.
All right, well, I flip over to the net worth chart on the left there. A little late, sorry. Kind of got distracted by all the action. All the celebrities, they're so beautiful. 7.6 on the Lycan, that's his net worth. 6.1 on the Magnus, doing also well. Looking for the four staff for the Morana. Bone 7 is really Bone 7's third, 6.2k net worth. Also, that's where the Anti-Mage is as well. And you can see he's about 3 minutes behind when you'd really like to have that Battle Fury coming online at 6.1, the Brewmaster at 5.4. And he did win out in that lane. Venomancer, Feta only at 4.7. The support, normally they don't go this far down the list, but the support, AUI 2000, having rotated towards the middle lane where Eternal Envy went to jungle, he's all the way up to 4.3. So doing really well. The Yule Scepter is done. Just finished it up maybe a minute ago.
Yeah. So big thing is Morana ended the killing spree, Magnus's mega kill streak, in fact, to get some hefty gold. So a 5 kill streak ended. Morana gets that, and it looks like they're going to get another successful fight. Great choke point here to try to go for the combo. Yeah, Macropire, Ice Path, everything here. DK Phobos swapped down, but still going down.
Got him. Auto-attacking. Oh, big RP, though, onto everybody. Feta is the one that's not here. Otherwise, it's a 4-man RP, but they survive to fight another day. The Fiend's Grip out. EE gonna go ahead and focus him down. Bone 7 with a double kill, pushing himself up to second net worth. The arrows from Bone 7 have been on point this game. As Eternal Envy continues to run people down, they'll just leave FNGB, whatever. Cloud9, they lose their two supports, but they do take down four people of Virtus Pro Polar. It's a 2,600 experience change, about almost 1,600 gold for Cloud9, so really, really good turn of events
in
there.
Top lane, dropping below half HP to Fanta's push here. He has the Aquila on, the Plague Ward's doing work, but DK Phobos will try to frustrate him a little bit here. Blink clap, but the clap doesn't connect, the Gale does, and he gets to walk away. And meanwhile, Eternal Envy stealing a double stack of Ancients from the Radiant side, so good gold just being taken out of the pocket of this Anti-Mage who wanted to farm that with Empower. Great RP, but the even better Fiend's Grip keeps Anti-Mage from following that up. So even though the Anti-Mage wasn't empowered, it didn't matter because he was pretty much dead before he got to cast the spell. So there were two support losses on Cloud9's side, and both of them were very close. Pylodai was like in mid animation for brain sapping to kill off his nemesis and to heal himself up significantly, but he just barely didn't get it off. And then after that, the Aphotic Shield and the Magic Missile chasing down Aoi as he stayed very long in that fight. But in the end, they still get a huge favorable trade, doing tons of damage to a tower, stealing Ancients, and obviously getting some clutch kills. So very good use of their early tempo, and it looks like they're going to go pretty soon onto some creeps. Aoi is going to snipe up at least two of those, and Macropire is a pretty short cooldown.
Yeah, it is definitely an ultimate that you can just throw out to stop some creeps or even farm some stacks, as here we go. Eternal Envy. Can I just start calling him Goku? Because I've been tempted to say Goku like 10 times already. Pushing down the bottom lane. We'll bring down the tier 2. Up top, his Anti-Mage trying to get some split push on. I think his Battle Fury is being delivered up right now. So it completes it at 19 minutes, 44 seconds on top of Treads and Poor Man's Shield. Not really the greatest timing, but at least he has it now. And if he can sort of, you know, keep this spread, I guess, between him and Lycan, it'll maybe be okay. He'd like to obviously close the gap, but Lycan also farms pretty fast.
Yeah, so as soon as he gets the Battle Fury, he tries to blink into enemy territory to steal their camps. It's actually going to be a stolen double damage run. His Bone 7 has to leap away here. There is going to be an arrow after the Yules. Great damage on DK Phobos, but immediately dispelled by the shield. Illidan, oh, Bone 7, but he's got 10 HP, and without a Photic Shield, they can't break the Nightmare, or sorry, the Fiend's Grip in time. Illidan's still dropping pretty low to that pure damage, and actually they extra are fully set up to do all the damage they need to here. DK Phobos blinks in, the Aphotic Shield helps Anti-Mage out, and Aoi's the one to fall.
Yeah, the burn should bring him down. He wasn't Viz from the Moonlight Shadow. Bone 7, who got away with about 10 HP, was still able to throw out some utility to the end of the team fight, but in the end, doesn't really matter. Jakira goes down, 1500 XP given up just for AUI's life, and now the free fortification is going to go out on the middle tier 1, and it should fall. TB is going to come in, though. They want to defend it. Morana's up to the north right now, looking to shoot an arrow. Lycan run it in from the south here. Who are they going to try to focus first? There's no ultimate here from Phobos, so they don't want to try to take this fight on the side of Polar. If they can retreat, that would be better right now. Hardy, he'll get off the Nightmare. Mag's going to go in. He'll bring back just one, actually. Brings in Feta. Feta already used the Poison Nova, and now Cloud9 onto a killing spree for Eternal Envy. going to continue to give that chase. Fatal will survive right there. And ZP Polar.
Is a pretty generous term. I would say whiffed. He didn't hit a single person with his shift queued poison on Nova. He TP'd, he shift queued it to immediately come out swinging with that ultimate, and nobody got hit by it. They just outside the radius on all counts. So very fortunate, but the poison Nova, a critical one at rank 2, could have absolutely destroyed that fight, and instead they get to walk out, they get to kill Pi, and they just lose their supports, right? Yeah, Venge got gunned down very early on. Abaddon stuck around for a bit, but he essentially traded his life one for one for the Bane. They do take the top tier 2 as well, and the mid tier 2, of course, we saw them push that. So it is worth noting that if Cloud9 even remotely win a fight, that they're able to follow it up with a lot more, and they're still able to fight in between the RP and split cooldowns.
Yeah, they're not as dependent on their ultimates at all.
Another thing that's worth noting is the Anti-Mage hasn't been able to really farm his jungle, as there have been sentries blocking out the western side, so it's been kind of frustrating for him. Fata just dropping intentional plague wards. This last plague ward he dropped was at 21 seconds. Because these things last 40 seconds, that's a blocking plague ward. So it just 100% intentional to disrupt the Anti-Mage's farm, and yeah, he's forced to just go for push, which team push is not what Anti-Mage is really about with a Battle Fury.
No, not at all. Definitely an individual hero. We'll see Little in trouble. The Fiend's Grip goes out. This one will net a kill. It's just on a support, but hey, it still stops it. I mean, if VP Polar want to take a fight now, it's 4v5. Sure, Bane is right-clicking a little less, but he doesn't usually lend too many right-clicks to the fight. As long as he spaces himself from his team, he won't. It's, what, 900 radius? I want to say.
On the
radius 900. No, the Vengeance Aura, negative Vengeance Aura.
Oh, yeah, most auras are.
Yeah, 900, so. Top lane, there's the free glyph for the top tier 1. A Mjolnir already finished up on Bone 7. They're going to Moonlight Shadow to initiate, feeling a little sheepish. They don't even go for the complete tower. It's actually still at half HP. They will just run away. I don't know if they saw anyone in lane. I guess it must be Eternal Envy down here in the bottom lane, farming it up. It gives away the Moonlight Shadows to initiate. And now I thought they were going to fake back. They are kind of fake backing on the side of VP Polar.
They got the force!
Here. RP onto Feta, but he's in the middle of everyone. He can throw out the poison Nova here, and the skewer through. It's like a free force step.
Oh,
it applies to everybody. Mag is going to fall down. Feta, very, very low, lives on about 30 HP, and Anti-Mage dies trying to blink away. They want to go for FNG right now. Fate is TP'd home, he's very safe. FNG looking to turn this around though, as well as the Brewmaster jumping in. It's DK Phobos looking to clean up, but so far it's a Bane and a Mirana. Mirana's core, but bringing down the Anti-Mage and slowing him up even more while this Lycan just now, what is it, 6,000 gold ahead? Totally worth it.
Might be even able to catch out Lil if he went anywhere near the creep wave, but as he does not, it's just going to be a quick clear out of this. They've got the movement speed, they've got the crit, and they can just destroy those creeps so damn quick. Lil, whoa, getting the stun up. Goodness, that is a dangerous place to be. But
nice swap on AUI.
That's even worse. So AUI is actually probably going to be the one to be gunned down if DK Phobos gets the mana he needs. Right now, just blinking, right-clicking, but there's the missile, and that's going to be a kill. So in that last team fight, obviously there was some really good disruption from Pylidai. Didn't made it so that Dendi couldn't follow up with what he wanted to because of the nightmare, and then kind of ended up sacrificing himself, falling on his own sword so that Fata could live. He threw out the Nova with Aghanims, and we even saw that although the Anti-Mage has Spell Shield, with the Gale, the Sting, and the Nova all on him, he couldn't even TP out in time. The damage per second is just so insane from that ability, mitigation or not. Nice snipe from EE. Still has that Aegis available. They're throwing out. Oh, they got a gem. Yeah, they have a gem.
I was about to say, they just hit him with like 5 spells blind, so I'm starting to think that they weren't blind.
Yeah. None of them were single target, so it's easy to be confused, but the gem is there on Magnus. It was purchased by him, so Dendi trying to make use of that. Against the Moonlight Shadow mostly.
I think you've been calling Magnus Dendi for like the minutes.
That is a mistake. He played Magnus.
No, later. I know why you're doing it.
Yeah, was it the last game that he played?
Yeah, it was the very last game where he had Dendi Magnus in the mid lane, so easy.
Yeah, I've probably seen that 4 times by now. Shit.
It's alright, I didn't want to correct you, but whatever.
No, you're right. Thata, Dustin? Yeah, it's just going to throw out some...
It's a compliment, right? Like, if Mag's being confused with Dendi, then he's probably pretty happy.
Oh, let's check the well cam. Lil dropping low. He'll live just barely. But, Yeah, FNG, maybe not so much. He does have a TP.
He's borrowed some time, but...
But there is the Yule, so there's no way to get out for him.
Yeah, we'll land the Ice Path without it. Pilot Die here as well. Doesn't have mana for the Fiend's Grip, but they don't need it. Right-click him down. No one's coming to the rescue of FNG. He'll get to the trees.
It's an arrow. Can they follow it up? There's an RP. Just the wolves alone might be able to finish it off. They're invis. They walk right up to him. The magic one keeps him up, and he does have a decent chunk of armor with that medallion, so he will survive against the wolves. No easy crits before the magic one heal came. So, in the end, it's just the death of the Abaddon, death of the Venomancer, but almost half the tier 3 tower in mid's HP.
Little almost as a Yule Scepter, so it'll be a little harder for Eternal Envy to focus him down. Maybe, well, anyone really, to focus him down. So that'll be nice. We'll pull up the items at large. Blink on Mag, Blink on Phobos. Not a surprise there. Pilot Dice picked up a Blink, so that's going to be a really nice pickup for him. He can play back, play defensive, find the Fiend's Grip when he wants it. The Mjolnir on Bone 7, I know I mentioned that a while ago. AUI obviously has had that Yule Scepter forever since he got the mid farm after a bit. And we've got a Desolator, Necronomicon Desolator Vlad's, and a Medallion of Courage. I think Eternal Envy, he was upset earlier by someone's armor value.
Indeed, and probably will follow it up with the AC just to be even that much more frustrating. If he goes BOT, AC, and then starts working to sell the medallion, he can really deliver a huge amount of damage in a very short span of time. The Necro 3, the mana burn on the Necro 3 melee minion is physical, so that is going to be enhanced by any kind of negative armor, as well as, of course, every single auto attack delivered. Howled up, they're going right on to this tier 3 tower. Gets the Desolator debuff and then backs off so the wolves can finish the job, but it's going to be the Brewmaster to initiate.
Yeah, he was coming up from the south there trying to get that side attack. He'll jump on, but the Moonlight Shadow. And it looks like Magnus has got blown up on the other side of this fight here from Eternal Envy, just doing way too much damage. Crits there in that ultimate form. And let's see what they can do.
Second arrow onto Anti-Mage. It does get shielded off. Eternal Envy now leaving. But let's just see how fast Mag got destroyed there. A big crit, 560 some odd damage from the Lycan. And oh my gosh, Illidan going in.
I'm surprised Feta doesn't throw out the Poison Nova right there. He was pretty close to dying. He will survive. There's Eternal Envy, though. He's got two lives right now. Phobos does not have that Primal Split available. Also, playing Bane versus Abaddon sucks. It's like the worst thing in the world, but Pilot Die is doing pretty well regardless. Little's going to run in and will maybe get out with the Cephalotic Shield. It's going to be pretty close. Eternal Envy still on the chase. Pilot Die even lending some auto attacks. Illidan is going to jump right on him, telling this Bane to get out of there, but Bone 7 lands a fantastic arrow onto Illidan. FNG now battling it up with Feta, borrowing that time, but they're really just creating some time of their own on Cloud9 as they just bring down the racks, and now they'll go ahead and get out of there. They weren't really worried about killing anyone, and everyone's just dying after the fact.
It's just so brutal. They just lose life after life after life. Even the spell shield, not enough to keep them alive through this. Mag going down. This is the second time he's been blown up in about a second and a half. The crits, there was a lot of static charge proccing when he was in his first life. This time, it's just the Necro dropping him down. That Desolator doing work. The Drunken Haze, not even enough. And the racks are going to be falling with it. They don't have the respawns to keep this building alive, and with it might be their chances here. They don't even get to disrupt too much with a nice Yule's combo on a DK Phobos. He will split and will be forced out, but they've just lost three racks in total.
Yeah, that's never good. The mid lane is completely down right now. I can look back after we see what happens to AUI right here. Was it the range or the melee in the bottom lane? I'm not quite sure, but AUI is in some trouble. He bought a blink up, still has 1,000 gold, and yeah, they got the important one too. Eternal Envy focus that melee racks down, no problem.
Yule's coming out for DK Phobos? He doesn't even have the components. I'm a little confused on that one.
Did he buy the wrong recipe?
There's nothing else that he would buy, so I'm guessing it's what he wants. It's just weird.
That is a little weird. Wait, what are you talking about? That's for Little.
It is. Okay, there was a Brewmaster was using the courier and screwing with Lil somehow. I guess the gem was trying to be pulled off of it. Either way, we switched it up. We got the arrow here, and that's gonna be a dead pilot die. No ghost scepter, no force staff. He's gone.
Space created.
I don't know. I don't know if you can attribute that to a tactical feat. There are many that you can, especially with
what do you mean? Like it's farming. Space
utilizes
created.
The space, but. As it stands, unless Bone 7 takes this rain tracks down bottom. Which they very well might. That thing's not regening, and that's a pretty big wave.
And Bone 7 is pretty farmed as well. Starfog can clear up everything.
Why doesn't he just jump in? Do you think it's bait? I guess he thinks it's bait with everybody.
He's like,
else.
Surely they're defending this, right?
Nope, it's gone. It is space created from pilot eye. Holy
Phobos
shit.
Is going forward. He's going to try to find AUI once more. There's a very nicely that blink dagger. They didn't quite know about it. He bought it and got it from the graveyard. And that time they try to jump on him. The Yules doesn't damage yourself, so you can't blink out of it. It'd be funny if it did damage, but anyways, Illidan ice path caught up. Fiend's grip as well. He'll be able to Manta out after the aphotic shield from FNG. But the big Void Nova goes off. Bone 7 very low. Pilot eye melted. But mag FNG everyone the poison. There's too much. It's getting them so low, and well, it looks like they are still going to be able to TP out. Faded didn't really move too fast by past the tower, and Magnus will end up dying. Earth Panda, I think, is the only one up, right? So this is Phobos, yeah. Coming to the Earth Panda. They were so close to killing that Earth Panda, which would have been the death of Brewmaster, and it looks like no TP. They are going to be killing the Brewmaster. Meanwhile, all this is actually truly space for the Lycan. Eternal Envy is just pushing up top this whole time, and DK Phobos, he's hard to kill, but they'll get him eventually.
Yeah, with the last tier 3 tower down below, half HP, and the fact that two lanes of racks have already been taken down, it's only a matter of time before the split push absolutely destroys VP Polar's base. Like, they can't stop backdoor production from happening. You can just chip away at it with wolves if you want, or necros, or you can just go for the full brute force. They made a great initiation, one of the first really good RPs of the game here from Mag, but it just wasn't sufficient. They weren't able to follow it up with enough after Anti-Mage was under so much pressure. There's a bunch of Fiend's Grips and stuff being thrown his way. Good shields are coming out from FNG, but you can never have too much of a good thing. Like, in this case, they need more. They need to keep this Anti-Mage in the fight the entire duration, not just kind of in and out every time he can blink.
Eternal Envy. How many times has he had Invis Rune in this game? He's just, like, walking over to the top lane.
He's
dropping the Necros, and right now they're going to engage in mid with the Moonlight Shadow, and they actually realized this first. I think Envy honestly went in a little too early right there. If they had just engaged in the middle lane, Eternal Envy would have cleared out the racks 100%. Maybe some communication, maybe Eternal Envy just doesn't care. Brings down the tier 3 and the racks, I'm sure are going to follow pretty soon. Roche,
the reason he went in early was because of the creep wave in mid was being destroyed. That was what was breaking backdoor production. If he didn't go in then,
there you
go. It would be BD on the tier 3.
The mystery has been solved.
So, forced timing, but nevertheless, some good damage. The range racks is full, the melee out of the 1k and the 2-3 is dead. So, two structures in the way of Cloud9's victory, and I dare say, if they have a demolition order, then they don't have long to fulfill.
Phobos, he's got a plate mail. That 1400 gold probably going to turn into probably an AC. Shiva's Guard wouldn't be too crazy for him either. I mean, the hero does like some mana. The big magic, what is it even called? Mystic Staff, there you go. 2700 helps with the mana pool, but the way this game's going, I don't think he's going to find another 2000 gold but by the time it's over, so.
Yeah, here comes a game-breaking pickup from the Bane. Pilot Eye with this last creep camp acquires the 35-minute
mech.
No, it's a legit item if it wasn't for the fact that they have this absolutely destroyed this game. I mean, the kills sword means nothing compared to if you just look at the structures on the map. I mean, the base has been completely gouged out. They have everything going for them, and it's gonna be Illidan sniping out the DD rune, getting a nice lucky bash and bringing down the Morana very quickly. That rune snipe. I'm not sure why Bone was just sitting on it for so long, but end of the day, they get it, and now it's going to be Illidan to try to bring down Roche. The Wolf Scout and the Plague Wards in the pit, just causing frustration before the disables come through. Bane can blink to the high ground here for a great Fiend's Grip, but he knows FNG has the shield, has to wait for it. Yeah. And he actually goes on to the Western Front.
And there's an RP just onto Pilot Die. I'm not sure that's the best target, but I guess they don't want to deal with the Fiend's Grip at all. Moonlight Shadow goes out, and there's the dust. It took Abaddon a little while to use it. Now the self-fuel seal from Little, but Eternal Envy is just going to bring him down. Yeah, this dog is hungry. It's also at their door. It's just absolutely obliterating them. Fate is going to get a Poison Nova. Looks like off to two of them. FG is probably going to die in base or just die right there. Can't even TP out. And now Phobos, he's left the building. He blinks up. It looks like Pilot Die went to follow him. Everyone else trying to give chase as well. The Gale just misses. and now he's going to try to TP out. I don't think they've got anything to keep him there, so he'll be fine. Eternal Envy wastes no time. He goes in, he'll finish up the Roche. AUI already pushing. I think he's liquid firing the tier 4s right now. He's that far into the base, and Envy cleans up the Roche, no problem. Grabbing that Aegis now at 36 minutes.
Yeah, again, Intune's just going down to the damage over time effects. Just too much with the Veil of Discord, with the maxed agged up Poison Nova, and of course, just with the Jakiro on top of that. Like, they are in such a good state to bring people down, and DK Phobos eats an arrow. Like, it's just, they couldn't afford any more mistakes that last fight. They're outgunned. They don't have the net worth to try to fight this out, especially not the supports, but in this case, not Illidan either. GG should be coming out in just a moment. They do pick off the Morana, but these racks are so easy for EE to bring down.
Yeah, basically. Anti-Mage giving the Morana a lot of hate and brought her down twice in the last two fights.
There's the Aegis, here.
And there's not going to be any shapeshift coming out of this. One of the weaknesses of giving Lycan that Aegis, and he's not even quite able to get that Rax. Does get the melee very low to 150, but that will regen. Probably won't really matter at the end of the day, but something small going the way of VP Polar right now.
Yeah, I don't see it being a cause for them to turn it around, but it is still keeping them in the game. Until that melee Rax falls, they still can try to win this one. I mean, 37 minutes in, the Anti-Mage has Battle Fury and Power. He can clear out big waves pretty quickly, but it's Mega Creeps that will be the nail in the coffin. We do see the nice defensive heals coming out from Jakiro, but he doesn't have the blink off cooldown to get away, so he will be going down in the end, though. In mid, Fata is posturing.
Invis rune, been a lot of them. He went Veil of Discord as his fourth item after the Blink Aquila Blink Aquila Aghanim Scepter. So, ton of damage coming up from Feta. It's actually ridiculous. He's going to go on it right here. Lands it on both of them, blinks back. They're going to throw out the Primal Split. Look how fast Mag is dropping down to about a quarter HP. That forced out the Primal Split as well.
He's going to die in Fountain, by the way.
Yeah, is he going to actually die?
He's going to die in Fountain.
It's close.
15 HP. Oh my gosh.
And now the Brewmaster has got to do something about this. He's stuck here, going to get blocked up by one of the Plague Wards. Illidan, though, coming in. FG is here. Everyone, the reinforcements for Polar running in, trying to save Phobos, trying to win this fight. They'll bring down Feta. It was a pretty cheeky play by the Venomancer, but in the end, it wasn't really worth it. Magnus didn't die, and they were able to get quite a few kills on the side of VP Polar afterwards. Cloud9, well, they're actually trailing in kills, but it doesn't matter. Look at this graph, man. They've been leading this like since the 9-minute mark when their pushing came online. It's just been all in favor of Cloud9.
So it's all about tick timings here. Venomous Gale dropped Magnus down to 9. Poison Nova drops him down to 1. It would have overkilled, but it's non-fatal. Then Sting hits for only 18 after he regened up a bit, and then Poison Nova brings him down to 1 again. He dropped down to 1 HP twice in the fountain, but none of it was fatal. Now we do see Venomancer coming right back up for another quick Nova, but it's just a bloodbath here on the bottom lane.
Yeah, Eternal Envy at this point is a little too strong. His singular damage coming out with like this Desolator build with the Necros and his crit from his wolf form is just insane. He is ripping through people. If he is on you for more than a second, you're dead no matter who you are in this game.
Mm-hmm.
Except Abaddon.
Yeah, no, except for pretty much him being the exclusive hero that could just say, well, fuck your time scale tables. This is borrowed time.
Time to borrow, that's his catchphrase.
No. We're done. But, yeah, Abyssal up on Anti-Mage, them just trying to hold this last vestige of hope. There's one thing I was going to talk about, and I have at this point forgotten it, so I'm kind of buying time
to talk about Dendi.
Think about stuff. No, we're done with Dendi too.
There's a bounty rune and a haste rune up right now. Roche, if they really wanted to wait for it, is going to be actually a while. Envy did it like not too long ago, but he did feed it with capital E's almost immediately.
I have no idea what it was. Oh well, it'll just haunt me for the rest of my life.
It's all right. Smoke's up for AUI. Looks like they want to just get this game over with. Smoke into the base, find a pickoff, end this game. I mean, let's see what's the reparation on the melee. It's actually back to full HP, essentially. Yep. So that's done well. Cloud9 maybe goofing a little bit here. Feta was trying to make a really sick play that didn't work out, and I guess Envy was as well. It's given Polar another 5 or so minutes.
Yep, so just looking for the opportunity here. It should be DK Phobos getting Yulzed and killed off.
Phobos, you can't evade Macropyre. He will go down. That's a good pickoff. He does have buyback right now, so obviously he's going to try to use it. But it's a nice pickoff for C9. That's a step in ending this game. Roshan 5. Okay, VP Polar moving in force. They want to find Pilot Eye. They smoked up for this. I don't know why FNG is going first. I guess he's the only one that can take the initiation, but he can't really keep anyone there. There's a lot of blinks this game. They'll find Feta. Nice defensive nightmare from Pilot Eye. Feta, can he get off the Nova? He's out of mana because he's being focused down by the Anti-Mage. So just as C9 find a pickoff, so do Polar. Envy, though, is in that top lane, pushing down quick to the racks. If he can just maybe he picks the range barracks this time, just at least to get it, another building out of the way, make that lane push a little harder. But he'll actually move off towards mid. The rest of his team going to be poised to push bottom lane. Still, Cloud9 trailing 2 kills, but in no danger of really falling behind. Well, XP's actually almost back to equilibrium, but...
Yep. So, I mean, Charlie's got that Blink Dagger. He can kind of jump on anybody when he wants to, though. He doesn't want to go in and get caught out by the RP. You know, nowhere near a refresher yet, but Mag has been able to at least do some good lockdown and could cause some real issues if the disables did come through. Yeah, Jakiro's carrying Mag's gem, so that's kind of a thorn in his side, is they don't really get to have any map control here. They don't have wolves to scout with. They have to do it manually or with Wave of Terror, and in this case here, the lack of Observer Wards is certainly hurting their potential to feel safe in their farming. Only one ward on the map, and in a relative... Oh, how he finds it immediately, of course.
He's the best, man. Well, the game has slowed down considerably. I feel like Cloud9 could probably just force the issue up there. I guess they're going to wait for the next Aegis, perhaps. Envy's still sort of infested in this top lane, pushing down. It should be about, I think, 2-3 minutes for that Roche to come back up. And then they'll probably group up as 5 and just go into the top lane. I'm not really sure. I guess they're scared of a big RP. The Primal Split is proving to be somewhat annoying. And Anti-Mage is getting pretty strong. He's got the Abyssal right now, the Manta, that Battle Fairy that he finished at 19 minutes, 40 seconds. He's come a long way since then. He's definitely got that buyback. Actually, no, it's coming off cooldown at 1 second. He's got buyback now. 4,400 gold. Could probably get maybe one more item and still have the buyback.
Oh, FNG.
Maybe in some trouble. Actually, could be Pilot Eye and Bone 7 that are in some trouble. There's only 3 heroes here for Cloud9. The Abyssal Blade goes out onto the Garana, going to get blown up immediately. And remember, that's a core. Almost going to have a Manta, a Mjolnir, and also working towards, I guess, potentially MKB with that Demon Edge in case AM goes Butterfly.
Yeah, that was quite surprising. They didn't go for the Moonlight on top of their smoke. They just went for the smoke of the sea, so they didn't really catch anybody off guard. The Yules went out on FNG, who is the target that would dispel things, but they didn't follow it up with the stun on the AM. So, yeah, end of the day, they just go ahead and end up feeding away Bone7's life, and now it's Anti-Mage to feel confident to go into the enemy territory. He knows he's not going to get arrowed, and that's a big thing. You can't farm away from your Abaddon if you're going to get arrowed. We do have a Fiend's Grip, though, and... if the Abaddon wasn't closer, then that would have been a real problem. But down up top lane, it's going to be the ultimate from Eternal Envy coming in. He has a blink. Swap back, and he's actually going to be in a bit of a rough spot here. They don't really have hard lock. The magic missile, no. He's going to get the BKB, and it's meanwhile, down bottom lane, the tier 4 number 1 is gone, and the secondary is almost destroyed as well.
I'm guessing that's somewhat the doing of AUI and also lots of creep. I think he's
he's
been sneaking into the base, and I think he's been throwing some liquid fires onto the tier 4s. I noticed
and
a couple
summits.
Of them. Yeah, also the wolves, the necro units, probably some plague wards being put down. So the tier 4 has finally fallen. The other one is extremely, extremely low. And VP Polar, still the same situation for like the last 10 minutes, just holding on for dear life, extending the game as much as they can, making it hard for Cloud9. And Roche is up in 45 seconds, so we know where Cloud9 will be in about a minute. And so do Polar, at least they... Well, I guess they don't, but soon, regardless.
So for now, the gem that was purchased by VP Polar, Lil, is also trying to take vision off the map so that neither can really have it. It's very valuable to have it against the Moonlight Shadow, but... yeah, end of the day, it's not preventing... them, it's Cloud9 from just taking over the entire map in general, spreading it very well. They've got the MKB up on Lycan, so even if a Butterfly does come out for the AM, which is casually just a quarterstaff right now, it's still going to be kind of rendered obsolete. Fata down bottom is a pretty prime kill target. He does have a blink and a TP, though, and he will use it to effectiveness. Going back to the Anti-Mage having this quarterstaff, it's very rare that you just see a casual quarterstaff on anybody. Usually it's turned into an item very abruptly, and then you never see it again. But in this case here, I think he might be showing it to say, hey, EE, I'm going butterfly. Then EE builds the MKB, and then he just sells the quarterstaff and builds something else. So it's a bit of mind games there, potentially. Otherwise, it's just a casual pickup he could afford at the moment he needed it. But generally, you prefer the TP scroll. Fata losing mana quickly, but the Moonlight Shadow will carry him away. And in fact, there might be no blink ultis from the Bane.
I like how Fata dodges that out in the bottom lane, and then still, like, Anti-Mage finds him in the middle lane. It's like Liam Neeson's playing Anti-Mage.
Nice. I would have to say the lack of four staffs is the reason why he's being so active and aggressive looking for solo picks. Yeah. The fact that he can abyssal on somebody, it means they're going to be caught out pretty well, and there's not much room for a slow Venomancer to run. Only 335 MS.
All right, well, game continuing right now. The Roche, that's what we talked about. There it is. It's respawned and it's almost already dead. They're bringing it down very quickly. Aegis and Cheese this time. They're going to throw the Aegis. That's the wrong graph. Aegis over to Bone 7, actually. He has been the target
Butterfly.
Of Anti-Mage. Yeah, Butterfly is done, but an MKB is already on the field. Eternal Envy's finished his. Bone 7 is not far at all from his MKB, so that Butterfly is met by already being pretty much countered.
Yeah, I was hoping he was just showing it and then going to pull a little bit of a feint, but in the end he finishes it out, and although it's a fine item on Anti-Mage, it is not going to do him any favors this game.
No, it's not. You got Flutter, though, at least, right? Yes. Flutter.
It's a fun could be interesting.
I hear an RP. It's going to be onto two. Catches Eternal Envy and AUI in that, but oh, Illidan's going to jump onto Fata, so Fata not able to. The Nightmare! Interrupted the Mana Void, and now they're going to try to turn it around onto Illidan. He'll blink out here. MKB's also going to be helpful in killing Phobos, but Lycan is down for like 100 seconds. Aegis, remember, was given over to Bone 7 on the Mirana, and he didn't even go down. He wasn't focused that much. That's a big kill, and Eternal Envy was not able to go ahead and use that cheese. MKB now being delivered on Mirana as well, and that was nightmare of month. I don't know.
No, I mean, the ulti still hit him, right? The 790 damage was received by Venomancer there, but the fact that he was able to live after that and walk away because they were forced to change targets is the big thing here. The Nightmare disrupted his chain of focus, and then the Moonlight Shadow is currently speeding away. Mag is the one with the gem, and he's just far too far away from Fata. So yeah, the Nightmare doesn't stop what happened, but it was able to make it so that it wasn't a fatal move.
I thought it interrupted the cast animation. So
it looked like it.
Yeah, I was like, at first I was confused even what happened because Venomancer just like disappeared but then wasn't dead, and I was like, what?
Yeah, but I get the cheat sheet of the combat log. So 790 damage delivered via Mana Void.
Oh, the secrets, man. Combat log.
Dude, I seriously, it's one thing that I love to do as a co-caster that
you can't really do it,
without looking extremely ugly and gauche.
I crashed my game with it yesterday, solo casting.
Yeah, you gotta watch that shit. But yeah, no, it's really a nice little addition where we get to see Mag surviving through 2-1 HP poison Nova ticks. And seven, and obviously seeing what happened there with the Mana Void. So yeah, it's just a nice little bit of extra depth that the viewers can get the information on, even though they don't want the whole gigantic combat log.
I mean, I can install my my WoW add-ons, get some combat logs up in here, some floating text damage.
Just big giant 10,000 damage.
10,000, yeah. What it's? I've never even played the new one, but I'm sure it's like a million damage per crit now.
Who knows?
Not sure. Somebody knows.
No. Nobody plays that game.
I don't know. I haven't been in it for a while, but
so pause coming through. It is Illidan's Storm Rage. Speaking of WoW.
Speaking of WoW.
Goes for the butterfly here. Bit of a mistake.
As well.
Not like he had many alternatives though. Like no matter what item you go, it doesn't change the fact that you're living on a prayer. It's just like The one cool thing that I do like about Butterfly is because it's so invested in agility, you get the huge benefit from Empower. Empower amplifies all agility items that you get by half as far as that value goes, not in terms of armor or attack speed, but in terms of the raw right-click you get from it. So that's why with Empower, he is actually hitting for 524. Because he has Agi Treads, Manta Style, and Butterfly. So all, and the Vladimir's buff as well, I guess, does amplify that by an additional 15%. So with plus 65%, this Agi really does mean a lot, even though, as mentioned, it isn't ideal against MKB.
Yeah, I mean, the stats are always going to be great. I'm saying, he got it for Flutter, man. 8 seconds of 20% move speed.
Hacks, you might as well sell your Treads.
It's like running with a knife out in CS. There you go. Now we've talked about two other games that aren't Dota. See how many we can work in. Oh, man, the pauses today. Well, they were actually fine until these last couple games. But
mm-hmm. By the way, as far as schedule goes, how are we looking for the rest today?
Yeah, let's bring that up. The next game is going to be MYI. Is that My Insanity, right? That's the acronym for that one. I keep wanting to say My Intent, which is like a North American organization.
Yeah, there's two MYIs, but
whatever. Yeah, My Insanity versus Cloud9, so we'll see Cloud9 playing again at 21:15, which is 2 minutes from now. So that one's probably going to be a little bit delayed, guys. If not a lot a bit delayed. Although one team's already here, right? Like Cloud9, all five of them are currently playing, so it's not like they're going to run away and disappear, although I'm sure they will try. And then My Insanity, hopefully they're already ready, so there won't be too much of a downtime. And then one more game after that, and that's the day. It's El Clasico! We get to cast El Clasico, although not really in its perfect form anymore, since Alliance is AK plus four stand-ins, but...
All right, Illidan going to take a hit here. He's going to back off. DK Phobos going in. The pause is concluded. The fight ensues. Pylai die with the Ghost Scepter to try to survive, but only for a moment. He will fall. Fata was saved with the help of that Bane earlier, and Aoi will be able to blink out as well. So they do live. Illidan on the hunt. Actually, let's see. The Yule's TP. Actually, just TP, unless the Bash. Oh, the Ice Path. Nice. So yeah, no Bash, no Abyssal off cooldown, and it will be the Jakira to slip away. But the big deal here is Envy's in the grave with Cheese, and he wants to be on the battlefield. He wants to be taking down those racks. The mid lane is being pushed out by Mag with his Empower, the bottom lane cleared out by Illidan before he steals enemy Ancients. But where does he go from here? How does this Anti-Mage actually become a huge force in this game? And the answer is pretty simply in his inventory now. The Heart of Taras.
Atos.
Excellent. Excellent. Go to Crimson Guard.
Yeah, Crimson.
49 minute Crimson
Guard. I think Vanguard's the answer, guys. He's got it. Yeah, Heart, probably the way to go. I mean, he needs that a little bit extra HP.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't do much else for him. I guess he could get, like, crazy damage. I mean, has he been dying at all recently? Like, I feel like it's been Anti-Mage kind of dominating this game for the last 10 minutes. Yeah, I mean, 9 made this pretty hard on themselves.
Yeah, it's been pretty difficult recently. I don't know. In this position, it really just comes down to Rax. Like, he has to find a way to make sure that the creep wave never hits base. So if he can go... I mean, he can't go orb effects on Anti-Mage, so a lot of that is alleviated. But just, like, if he can find a... I don't know what... I mean, he's got the... Like, I kind of feel like he's at his prime. Like, BOT's Heart... And that's what you get. Like, in Divine Rapier is kind of silly on this hero, but you could try. Either way, there's going to be a fight, and if this is a series of kills, then it might just be the
Sheepstick
game.
Sheepstick going to be unveiled here from Feyda on the Venomancer. He just picked it up. They're going to go into FNG. There's an RP for Magda on the two. Bane is down. Feyda not able to do anything. Down for 100 seconds right now. Illidan Stormrage going on to Internal Envy. He's going to have to use the Cheese, but Illidan is hitting so hard right now. Arrows coming in. It's not enough. Eternal Envy will survive. The Borrow time from FNG. The Yule Scepter up. Ice Path. Everything. Going to go ahead and throw it on there. They'll bring him down. Dead for 100 seconds, but that buyback is available right now. Gem on the deck, and we'll look at that teamfight recap. It's a 2-4-3, and that's without it was a Gale and a Blink. That was all Feyda was able to do. No Hex that he just picked up, no Poison Nova. C9 still win the fight.
Nevertheless, the carnivore tries Dairy, finds it to his liking, and he is able to get that full HP bar to gun down the anti-mage. We're going to be forcing a buyback here, most definitely, as they make their last stand. RP going to be on cooldown for 45 seconds, and without it, it seems almost preposterous to see them take this, but DK Phobos will try.
There's no Abaddon here either, and he's been keeping everyone alive for so much longer. Here's the split from Phobos, gonna Cyclone up, try to buy as much time every 6 seconds with that one. Might have actually just been a Yule Scepter, it seems short. Unless
oh, nice.
He'll swap him back. Beautiful play by the Vengeful Spirit. I thought there was no way they'd deal with that, but what a swap back. Macro Pyre to kill the creeps from Owie. Another, oh, he gets the tower. He gets the tower with that Liquid Fire. The tier 4 is down. The throne completely exposed, and all the while this is super difficult for Cloud9 to end this game. I feel like there is no way they lose it.
I don't know. At this point, they're obviously in a worse spot than they were 15 minutes ago, clearly. And until it's Mega Creeps, I have to say it's not over. I mean, even then, he's going to try to cleave it down with his Empower, but it still is just too much. Super Creeps, he can handle. Mega Creeps, I don't think so. We'll see. DK Phobos getting Fiend's Grip, getting arrowed, getting killed off. And he is going to be down for 94 seconds after having bought back. So that is... actually, no, he didn't buy back. It's just... I think he still has the death timer from a previous buyback, though, right?
Yeah, that seems probably...
No,
it seems
no, like no, no. It's 96 seconds, right? 96 seconds for a level 24 hero to go down. So I think it's just been a long game.
Yeah, I think that's it. 52 minutes again. We had one go an hour and 11 minutes. This one could potentially get there. Cloud9 played a pretty awesome game, and then they got pretty sloppy. And it's hard to say whether Cloud9 was just making mistakes or whether Virtus Pro was playing really well and forcing them out. We'll leave that for, I guess, the viewers to decide.
Sure.
But hey, we're definitely in the final stretches of it now. The Eye of Skadi is out. Bone7 just picked it up, had it delivered. The Sheepseek there, Fader would love to actually use that instead of being the Abyssal target. The Heart now going to be finished on Anti-Mage, and Anti-Mage no buyback, 5 minutes, 20 seconds. If he dies, game is going to be over.
Pretty crazy game so far. Venno, like you said, didn't really get to use anything in the last fight, but maybe a new opportunity here. Illidan will jump forward. He has the Heart. He's a lot more confident in himself. Essentially, if Eternal Envy's not there, he probably will survive. I mean, the Mirana does do some good right-click now, but even with her MKB, Mjolnir, and Skadi, I don't think that he's afraid of anybody but the Lycan.
Yeah, definitely not.
I guess if it was a Fiend's Grip, if it was a full Fiend's Grip, no shield, no interrupt, then other heroes that are not Lycan could bring him down. But
pretty scared
as it stands,
of the Hex too, I would think. But as long as Abaddon's up, nothing really matters.
Oh, good vibe, huh?
And Pylai dies into some trouble. There's the Moonlight Shadow. He'll buy some more time. They actually don't have any vision. They're going to try to surround him here, doing a decent job. But Illidan is now going to go ahead and take an arrow to the face. I thought Pylai Dai might want to go in. I guess Abaddon is standing right next to him, so there's no hope of doing the Nightmare or anything. Fado will whiff the Nova 100%, but can he find the
base
Sheep? He does right now. This is FNG they're trying to bring
he's
down.
He's going to the base.
Ghost Scepter, they're just buying the time. Meanwhile, Lycan will fall down for 100 seconds. Got some damage onto the throne. FNG is going to drop here. And now that Lycan's dead, Illidan not scared of anyone, as we just talked about. The Sheep's even on cooldown, and Illidan just going to go ahead and clean everybody up. Looking over onto Bone7, getting the bashes, finds the kill there. Three on Cloud9 dead. Ancient still under attack. It's AUI that's just trying to end this game now with the Liquid Fires. It's going to try to blink away. He's also got the Hex up on that support, Jakiro, and the Throne does not take much damage at all, just about 750. And AUI probably going to die for that.
Yeah, tries his best. The Ghost Scepter, the Yules. He does have the blink, but DK Phobos, oh, he doesn't blink in time. Unfortunate, but there you go. He's going to go down here. Four down for Cloud9. Now Fata tries to make a play against Illidan, but he needs to run. He needs to blink. He needs to hide, because there's no way, even with Hex, that you do anything to this guy. He's fluttering away. He says, come at me, and if he had vision, he would be abyssaling right now. But as it stands, the Venomancer distracts him. The courier goes out for Magnus to pick up what I believe is a refresher orb. Yeah, 675 gold off of that one. And Roche is going to be spawning in just 30 seconds here, not even. So very clutch Roshan timing. It's going to be almost down to this Roche who takes this game. We saw how impactful the cheese can be in the fight on the top lane, and obviously Cloud9 are going to be gunning for it. But if VP Polar are able to disrupt that for the first time this game, that would be absolutely immense.
Yeah, to be fair, I mean, Envy's been dying, so it's not going to just be one team fight that VP Polar needs, because Envy, he hasn't never used the buyback, right? Like, he still has buyback, Jakiro still has buyback, so even if they get wiped and VP Polar are able to start pushing into the base, the buybacks for Cloud9, still going to be there. So there's a hope of another defense, but game has, the game is hard, I think is the summary. VP Polar versus Cloud9 right now. Mag going to come in with another great RP on 2-2 and a bone 7 with that Scotty. Picked up an SNY even as like his fifth item, but the split here from the Panda, a little too much to deal with. Bane is down. Aoi's about to respawn, and I think they're going to get faded here. He'll go into the Moonlight Shadow. They have not been carrying this detection around. Do they even have that gem? Gem's on little for VP Polar.
Yeah,
so
he's had it, and he's just nowhere near the fight. He can't be because he dies so quickly, so it's weird, but essentially they don't use it against Moonlight Shadow, they're just dewarding with it. Anyways, in mid lane we're going to see the tier 2 drop very quickly to the double damage anti-mage. Right now, hitting with the Vengeance Aura, he was over, I think it was about the 700 per auto attack with the Vengeance Aura, but yeah, there we go. Oh, the big cleave, the big right clicks, and they're going to bring down Bone. Eternal Envy blinking away, but they're in pursuit. They'll swap him back, and they will get this kill. This is immense. Eternal Envy has buyback, but he will be forced to use it. Aoi, split pushing down bottom. Absolutely insane timing for VP Polar. I'm not sure what Cloud9 were doing there. Just jumping in 2v3 and assuming this game is in the same state that it was 30 minutes ago, which I assure you it is absolutely not.
It is not. It's dead even on gold, and it's getting there on experience, and let's not forget they're about 16,000 gold ahead, but this is a big push. They gotta go. They're going to cancel. Feta is going to cancel with the Sheepstick. He needs to.
He has to drop something. He's dropping his treads. He's getting a TP scroll, but he gets hexed.
I think that was too early.
Yeah, a little bit.
They needed to be able to cancel the TP. They gotta try to keep vision, but they can't stand out too far because otherwise Illidan will just kill them. Envy bought back and got Boots of Travel to go bottom where Mag and Little are defending right now.
Mm-hmm.
And that pulls Anti-Mage back off the top lane, so they're still not able to get much. They're always going to have
they
the threat
the buyback,
of the base
though,
being
that's
pushed
huge.
In.
You, as you mentioned, they haven't gotten that all game, but if EE gets the Roche, then I guess it really doesn't matter. He's getting MKB Bash procs here onto the Roche. They're just kind of slugging it back and forth, the little guy versus... Mike Tyson's punch out right here is essentially what we're looking at, but a little bit of Wolverine claws in the action, and if this goes the way of Cloud9, they're looking damn fine because they have the Aegis or the cheese on EE, and they have the other on another core, maybe Fata since he's been going down quite a bit, but the end result is still the buyback on cooldown for Lycan and Lycan alone, and they do refresher orb available for Magnus, which is just crazy important.
Why are they having such a hard time with Roche?
They don't have any lifesteal anymore. No Vlads.
Oh, yeah, he sold the Vlads. And Roche, I guess, does scale pretty hard when it gets to
Oh, yeah, he does. This is 58-minute Roche. This isn't your...
It's practically Dire-Tide Roshan right there.
If only it was given.
Without the other abilities, I guess. That'd be pretty funny. If Roche randomly sunstriked people. If anyone was in the pit, Roche just started randomly throwing sunstrikes. That'd be awesome, actually. Anyways, no buyback for 5 minutes, which is the big story here. I can only assume, yeah, Aegis is over onto the Lycan. So he's got one death in him. I'd like to see him try to fight without using his shapeshifts, but I guess if he dies first, no one else lasts that much longer. Will he even have time to get into the shapeshift afterward? It's kind of hard what life he decides to use that on is. They're at the door right now. Anti-Mage is at your door this time. And he's bringing down that tower very, very quickly. There's no fortify for another 1 minute and 40 seconds. Cloud9 probably hitting themselves in the head right now, the way this game has turned out, given how good it started.
At this point, racks don't matter at all. It's all about the throne, all about the tier 4 towers that make the throne immune. That's all that matters. Lycan BOTing to his wolfies, and he's going for the throne itself. Bank protection is not up, but the fortification is.
TP's
Illidan, his TP is available, but he's being fiend script. He has no Heaven support. He blinks out, but he's still down to 900 HP. Eternal Envy dropping out as well.
That's big. He's got buyback though, so that's actually just faster than a TP. He's back to the base. Everyone's actually back to the base. They'll bring down the Lycan.
This might be it. No, and he gets the blink out, but he has no shapeshift. Juke here. Oh my god.
I think Little's the one still holding the gem, yeah. And
yeah, that's the problem. They need the initiator to have the gem. The Brewmaster can carry it with a split, or maybe Mag with the. Yeah, the four step, the blink dagger, just say in pursuit. Right now, they just can't kill people that are in the shadows.
Really close to FNG. Although, if you hit him, it's not like you can jump on him and kill him.
Go, Cardi, go. 570 HP on the range, Rax.
Well, you said you said Rax don't matter, but I feel like the one that does is the only remaining one.
In that situation. I was saying, if Envy goes for Rax there and they just get to push into the Dire Throne, that's where it doesn't matter. Fair enough. It's a War of Attrition, then of course the Rax is of critical import.
I was even going to say,
TP's away from the... Okay, it was a detection thing again, right?
I'm sure it was. I have no doubt that it was lack of detection.
But he doesn't have any... Unless he had a rune. Did he pop a rune? No, it was... A tornado was off cooldown as far as I could see. I clicked it right when the TP finished, so maybe it was like a fraction of a second too late or something, but Venno gets out one way or another.
You were scepted by AUI? I don't know what he thinks he's doing. I guess he'll be okay. Illidan's not going to go for
Dude,
the
he's
chase.
He's been doing this all game, and he's managed it. So.
It's been pretty annoying. He's bet 9 times with 2917. He's got 5,000 gold. AUI looking so strong. Do you think it just goes Lincoln's? Just put that Lincoln's on the Lycan? I mean, maybe an Abyssal gets Lincoln's off or something?
Yeah, I mean, Lincoln's always good at this stage in the game. The hex he already has.
Refresher sheep, like, honestly.
Yeah, blink. Any hero with blink hex could consider a refresher orb, and Jakiro's not an exception to that.
Well, he's got enough for something. It's going to be buybacks for now. No buyback on Antimage for 5. No buyback on Lycan for 2. So those are pretty big deals right now. They'll both jump right into the ice path. The hex onto Mag running around the macro pyre. Moonlight Shadow's gone out. There's a haste even on Fatal right now. He's who's got the AC right now? Oh, it's a negative AC aura. Okay, never mind. I thought for C9.
They're letting DK Phobos slip away. The Poison Noble will take him down to 200.
Plus
a 5.
Perhaps.
It's going to be all the Venge.
Theta going to get jumped on by Illidan. Illidan Nightmared up right now on the low ground is FNG. Maybe just waiting for the Fiend's Grip to be thrown out. Pileidai has essentially stopped using that ability, and the fighting in the bottom lane looks like it will cease for now unless Mag wants to go in with RP. He's got Refresher as well.
Okay, so the next thing is they killed off the Venge, but they let the Brewmaster live. So they have the negative Vengeance aura, and an arrow will not connect. Cheese is now on the Morana. The Bone 7 has Cheese. Eternal Envy is kind of playing his game on top with all his cooldowns available. But it's down to this. Fata with his ulti coming up in a moment, but Illidan going in now.
Wow, the blinks out were super quick there by Cloud9. And I don't know about that Hex. That seems really early from Feta. And up top, yeah, is the RP. Was it used? Yes, it was. One of them. He's got another one. It will get the range. That's Eternal Envy finally taking out the range racks. Now trying to run into the trees. He's going to blink. He blinks and he Boots of Travels out. And meanwhile, the rest of the team still fighting. DK Phobos going to get off the Primal Split here. Rock out onto Pileidai. Bone 7 definitely falling. There's no Mana Void, but they don't really need it. Pileidai maybe going to drop. AOI trying to keep him alive right now. Meanwhile, Eternal Envy healing up in base as his allies will drop down. But at least it's the range racks that has fallen here. Half health on the melee.
I don't know, man. If they had just refreshed RP'd for the Lycan,
they would have killed him.
They'd be in such a better spot in the game right now. But as it stands, only a half HP melee racks. Is keeping them in the game right now, and yeah, Lycan is coming right back out to the battlefield. For now, it's going to be onto the jungle, but he has the BOTs, and he's already sending his wolves out. So those Invis wolves walk into the base, and if they leave it with backdoor protection down, he's going to just take the melee racks outright. No fortification.
Yeah, definitely missed a big opportunity.
There it is.
Eternal Envy's buyback was on cooldown. It might not have been long enough because it just came back. If they killed him, it would have been 30
they
seconds.
Lost Rax
because
they didn't RP.
Oh, wow. Everyone just TPing in to try to stop this, but it's too late. The Rax is already down. They'll get the Abyssal Blade. They can RP if they want. They'll kill Envy. He's got buyback, though. And that's the Mega Creeps. I mean, it's still not game over yet. Actually, DK Phobos is going to succumb to the poison of the Venomancer. And Venomancer Feta will TP back to base with 6,500 gold this game, striving to be the longest.
Now look how
today.
Quick Illidan still dispatches these Mega Creeps. It's still relevant that he can take these down in about 4 quick swings without losing any HP because of the Hardened Butterfly. So pretty big deal, but the Throne is very vulnerable now with only a few Moonwells keeping them, keeping the base decorated. Either way, we do see them going in for the all-in play. They're going to force Eternal Envy's buyback, and they do have one RP. Not both, but one.
Yeah, we'll watch the Anti-Mage up here. Going on that top tier 4, the buyback from Eternal Envy.
Committing to a base race.
Wow. And there's some people there ready to defend. FNG is one of them. I don't think he'll be able to stop the Lycan from attacking anything. Manta Illusions working on the racks. All of VP Polar is actually falling back just because Eternal Envy.
Just trying to cancel TPs, trying to keep him back, but now TK Phobos goes in on him. Eternal Envy still not pushing in, and it's going to be Aoi 2000 to take a spill here. Buyback is available on him, so he's willing to risk it for everything, and he's still waiting. It's patience.
That patience from Eternal Envy.
Yeah. That was a weird fortification. I'm surprised they forted for that melee Rex. I think the fortification for the throne is too important at this stage. Either way, they have Eternal Envy pop with the shapeshift going in. FNG has his borrowed time, so he's not a target. The throne is the only target, and it is being hit right click down by the wolves. But
they let one TP go out. I think it was Anti-Mage that got back.
Yeah.
They don't want to let Mag back with that RP, and Eternal Envy's already well fallen back.
Oh, not gonna get him. Oh, the hex! Mag going down. No buyback on the Magnus. This is... he has 45 gold until he gets it. Just a few seconds to wait here. I guess he will have it if he needs it. And checking Roche early, but not gonna be likely to spawn. We do see... I mean, this is a tense situation. No buyback on anybody but Mirana and Bane. Though, in 20 seconds, Anti-Mage, the big one, will be back.
Yeah, it's pretty funny.
Dude.
This game has been teetering with Anti-Mage with 4 minutes left on buyback, and then Lycan with 4 minutes left on buyback, like, back and forth. Like, the teams have had the opportunity to get the pickoff, but they've just never been able to do it when the buyback wasn't available.
That's insane.
It's back for Polar, because, like... There you go, Anti-Mage can buy back, Eternal Envy can. If he dies here, it's probably the game, and they're going to be the ones to get aggressive. The Scotty attack's going out, Bone 7 going to go on some creeps after the Mantis split.
Bigger.
And they've got Eternal Envy, he'll BKB up, he'll be able to run away, and now Pylai dies in trouble. Is just the support, does have buyback as well. AUI doing what he's been doing a lot this game, just in the bottom lane being annoying. Goes for a 4 staff even right now for the utility. At 67 minutes, big swap back, blink away, back to the same spot. Yule Scepter up. Ice Path to retreat. Wow, what a well-placed Ice Path from AUI. Getting both of them, but it might not matter because Illidan's the one down here. Another 4 staff out. He's trying to buy so much space. Look at the throne. The creeps are starting to hit now. This is what's really important. Aoi dies. He's dead for 2 minutes. They're bringing the big creeps back into the fountain right now. So their back's up against the wall. Throne taking some damage. I think it's regen to full HP a couple times already, and now still down.
The reason Aoi dies there is because of the pure damage changes in 6.82. Wave of Terror and Urn were both canceling his Blink Dagger, nothing else. So when he was ghosted up, they were able to cancel his Blink with the friggin' Urn of Shadows. And yeah.
Good item.
Stupid item. Jeez, that's ridiculous. But I guess it's a pretty low value 6 slot. Under other circumstances. But anyways, Illidan down bottom takes an easy tier 2 through backdoor protection if he pops the Manta, but right now he's holding it and just chopping away. There's the Manta. So Arrow will come out, taking down an illusion, and might force Illidan to leave this tower to regen. Yeah, I don't know if he finishes it. He's committed.
Creeps
he gets
here.
But top lane.
Yule Scepter up, Feta. Let's little put him up in the sky. Feta gonna try to push. Just drop some plague wards around this ancient or something. Meanwhile, Illidan trying to push the bottom lane. Ancient is under attack. The creeps trying to bring it in, and Eternal Envy falls back once again.
Just forcing
They're
in.
They're gonna wait 3 more minutes, like, guaranteed. And Roche is up too. This could be the next big area of contest. Everyone in the area for Polar just left, so I think it's gonna go the way of Cloud9. They've got what? This is gonna be 4th or 5th Roshan this game? Roshan with 16,000 HP right now.
Let's see the art of the buffs on this thing. Why is it... Oh, because the Desolator. I'm like, why does it have any armor? Stygian. But, yeah, he's pretty big boss. 16,000 HP, just chewed through in seconds here from the lineup of Cloud9. They will put Aegis on the Lycan, and they will put Cheese on Pilot Eye for now. And, soon enough, they'll be looking to just all in on this Ancient. These Mega Creeps are still pretty easy for Illidan to take down, but everybody else will struggle. Like, even the Brewmaster, his big crits, his Empower, he'll be hitting away for several seconds before he actually clears it out. I don't know why Illidan is farming Ancients, by the way. He has 13,000 gold. You don't need any more money.
It's a habit, dude. You're just like, what
it
do
really
I do?
It really is. But when you're at 913 CS, when you're at 750 GPM over 70 minutes, let somebody else clear the Ancients. Just counter push, that's all.
And all of this started off a 19-minute Battle Fury Now he's up to 900 big boy last hits.
Look at these graphs. This golden experience graph before the final clash here. BKB comes out. DK Phobos not connecting with anything. And that is a 5-second BKB, so a short cooldown.
I feel like I need to showcase view the creeps, because like you don't see the Megas that often, and they got their new upgrade.
Pretty cool.
So they look pretty cool.
Did you show the golden experience graph, though? It's fucking ridiculous.
Yeah, I did. It is a bit ridiculous. Wow, Feta jumps in, by the way, while I'm in showcase view. DK Phobos. Yeah. Oh, he gets RP'd! He should have buyback if it's not on cooldown.
Yeah, he wouldn't play like that if he didn't have buyback.
Yeah, he's got buyback right now. DK Phobos will get the kill. That's the primal split. Gonna be
Once
thrown
you
out there.
You shouldn't play like that at all, but...
I would also have argued that.
But nevertheless, you at least he has buyback.
Like, where could they be? Our creep are pushing into the base in every lane. I think I'll go in 1v, potentially 5. I don't know. Crazy decision, but he made it. Probably why Cloud9 is in the situation right now. And I think right now, this just hit the longest game of the day. I wouldn't have guessed we'd have 2-hour and 10-minute games. We had a lot of short ones as well, though, so.
Yep. So now we see this situation where we have the super farmed Lycan popping his shapeshift, looking to go maybe for a Rax play, maybe an Illidan Storm Rage play. He's all by himself, but a beauty in from the Abaddon. If they don't kill this creep, he'll get the shield. Illidan gets to pop everything, but he doesn't get to TP home.
And some support coming in. Mag with no RPs, actually. Looking at that, he does have one.
Okay, I don't even know if that matters. We'll see the Ancient taking some hits here. 3k. And they do disrupt the TP, but Anti-Mage is still able to blink out here. Now, on the courier that just died is Refresher Orb for Illidan, but all that would be refreshing is an Abyssal Blade.
Yeah.
I guess BOTs, maybe, if you really need that much mobility. But generally speaking, you're just refreshing Abyssal Blades. So, yeah, he's just rolling in dough, and I think that was like No, they don't have two couriers. I thought that was maybe like a pocket courier for him, but it is the team's courier that they do lose. In other cases, it doesn't cost too much to buy a new one. Gun continuing to go up on Fate. He loves this item because, especially when you get up to 5, it's a very short cooldown. You can... Hell, if it's big creeps, if it makes creeps, you can tip the scales with it. Like, whatever.
Yeah, it's got the Veil too, so that's a ton of damage coming out. It could blow up the supports. You might be able to make sure Borrow Time doesn't happen. Like, if you burst that damage, it won't proc. Seems like a sort of a long shot, but I guess you could go for it. At this point, whatever works. I think maybe Ethblade is better, though. I guess no, you don't go into a ghost form when you shoot it anymore. Some defensive aspects to that item, as well as the burst damage. But whatever, Feta goes for Dagon. He's been playing pretty reckless for a lot of this game, so why not go for the Dagon now? In the tree line. And they're going to go onto Phobos, the Poison Nova. And he's going to get away. I mean, we've already seen how much the Poison Nova with his abilities and also the Veil of Discord is just killing people.
Jump blinking, and the Shift Cube blinks off of BOTs with the Shape Shift active. Bunch of RP into Super RP. RP
Another
number
RP.
Two, not even needed because they want to wait for the Aegis to come out. No wolf form. There is buyback, but the death of Eternal Envy once more. This is his 7th death this game. All of them very consequential.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I guess he's only died 7 times in a 70-minute game. It's like a death every 10 minutes, but there were some pretty questionable plays strewn.
He's had a lot of Aegis deaths too, right? Like he's
yeah,
had least,
that's
I
true. He's probably died like 14 ones. Times.
Man, this game, it's so intense. It's so difficult to push into this, but as it stands, the big deal is bringing down this Anti-Mage twice. He's the one who's actually clearing out these creeps. Everybody else can just kind of barely do it. Like DK, Phobos, with the Empower, he can take it down one chunk at a time, but it's not nearly the same. Actually, I think there's a point in time where Brewmaster gets a Battle Fury, too.
Just to clear down the Omegas.
Yeah.
Oh, he might be going to the grave right here. Where's the Dagon? He's not going to throw the Dagon? I'm surprised. I mean, why not? He's got a ton of mana to work with.
Okay, no, he doesn't at all.
He would have killed him if he just Dagon. He might still kill him.
He's dead anyways. He is. Oh,
BKBs.
I can't even see the buff of BKB. Apparently there's a cap on buffs. Back in the base, Illidan gets arrowed. Now he's hit by the Fiend's Grip, and FNG, who was nightmared up, could not dispel it. Now he dispels it. Illidan goes for the TP. It's canceled. He's down for 120 seconds, or more likely, until he buys back. FNG, skirting the tree line, will be able to slip away, and there's the buyback on the Anti-Mage. Just in time for Eternal Envy to come back in, and this is important, because all of Cloud9 have buybacks, and two of them have 50. So what this means is they can beta fight on the first life of either the Lycan or the Venomancer, and then jump back in with a buyback BOT, assuming the creep doesn't get killed off. So that's a huge advantage, because they can fight in kind of 7v7, because of the fact that they only have two BOTs. But the big deal here is that there's only 1 AM. There are two Lycans, there are two Venos, there's only 1 AM, and that's huge. Along with that, Lycan has Cheese. So he's working with three health bars here if he wants to play an all-in strategy.
I'm gonna go back to Feta. Why didn't he just Dagon Brewmaster? Like, he had a level 2 Dagon. He would have got the kill. And kills at this point are so big, because you could have forced another buyback. Brew's one of those heroes with a buyback.
I don't have an answer.
It's just... he's goofing her off, man. Won't have that in my class.
Fata gonna drop down. He hexes the real one, but still taking a lot of damage here. Gets all the damage over time, but then gives Mana Void in the face. Three people hit by the Nova, though, and this should be cleanup time for Cloud9.
I'm yawning, I'm sorry.
So it's been a long one, but nevertheless, very, very interesting. FNG dropping down just outside of the 400 HP threshold, so he keeps his borrowed time, but he's right-clicking against Wolves, gets arrowed, and the borrowed time is procced based on that alone. So waiting, there's a swap, but here's Eternal Envy on the front line. Death of the Abaddon not coming back, and EE pops the
Lycan
cheese.
Getting blown up, had to use the cheese, will now blink out with that max move speed. I hear an RP, I don't see an RP, there's just too much going on, it's a little further to the south. They'll land that, I think, onto Feta.
I don't think he connected. I think he missed.
Oh,
but either way,
the RP. He's got another one at least. And let's see. Bone 7 still trying to deal with DK Phobos with the split. Pylai die does have a Fiend's Grip. Again, ability's been somewhat useless. If he can find it here, he'll throw it. DK Phobos not able to TP back in time. And this is going to be forcing a buyback. That'll mean no buybacks right now. Feta just bought back. The other four members of Cloud9 are retaining theirs. And now Illidan and the middle lane trying to push it out as quick as possible. And yeah, Brew's the only one, but they killed him. He's gonna force it out. Now they don't have any. That's what I was getting at. I got ahead of myself.
They gotta make sure this Drunken Haze is very effective. Like, the BKB timing for Eternal Envy, he wants to take off the Haze and wants to go for the throne, but double RP from here. Great follow-up from Illidan, and they wipe them out of the base. Bone 7 has to go in full retreat, and a nice juicy creep wave for Illidan once again as he racks up.
Nice swap.
Okay, the swap in. Can they
get him? Lil's been doing so much.
Out of the leap! Oh my god, Lil! What a fucking play! Cyclones the leap, catches him in the base, he's down again, and they need to force these buybacks. Force the buyback on the Lycan, force the buyback on the Marana, and then get back to defend your Ancient. That's the end game. But for now, Pilot Eye stalking up on the top lane. Down bottom, of course, it's IO 2000. They just won't let the creep waves pass those steps.
Oh my gosh. This is ridiculous.
This is absolutely insane.
If you need proof that Vengeful Spirit's a great late game hero, I think Little is proving that in this game completely. Like, that swap has been on point. They've caught so many people off guard with it. The blink, the swap, he doesn't even have an Ags yet.
No, the blink is all you really need. And then that Yule's play, holy shit, that was insane.
Yeah, Nags makes the hero kind of fun. That range
it's fun.
Is hilarious.
And, potential, but I won't say like it's something that every Venge has to
have. Yeah, definitely not. There's definitely items to go way before that, but... well, 78 minutes. It's the same story that it's been for the last, 40 minutes?
The current gold graph? The current gold...
Equilibrium. Three XP's about to go back to that, too.
We have three people above 4k current gold. We do see a split come through, and that they didn't get anything with it, right? That was a potential misplay, a blink out right when it happened. Actually, did not catch when they used that. Seemed maybe on an illusion. There were illusions in mid.
Illidan's just like unkillable right now. They can't do anything about it.
Oh.
He's going to jump in, gets an Abyssal Blade. Mana Void off onto the main. That's going to force another buyback there. They're trying to bring down another lane of racks, but look at this. Eternal Envy already into that lane, trying to push it in, bringing in the big creeps. But the Cleave brothers are here, man. They're not going to let it happen. They're not getting up that steps. They've done a brilliant job of defending this Ancient, and it's almost got up to full HP again.
There's a Hex coming out onto Lil. Poor little Vengeful Spirit should not be getting out of this one. and Nightmare, Ice Bath, everything. He goes
that
down.
Nightmare, however, was actually
Roche again.
Dodged. Roche number eight.
The 14 armor, 17,000 HP Roshan says something. But in the mid, it's the Mag double RP. On to two. Skewering him back. Huge damage coming out. Fata will fall. The leap away from Bone 7. He just tries to right-click to do something with his life. But in the end, he will fall. Has buyback. Will need to use it. Defensive TP from DK Phobos. He's going to guard the creep wave. Guard the base. But Eternal Envy still BOTs to the front. He's got double damage. The wolf is at your door. Do you have the TPs to deal with it? Right now, it's Anti-Mage coming back. And yes, they will be able to route the wolf from their base, but the fact that Anti-Mage comes back means that they're under less pressure.
He didn't. It got canceled.
Okay. So I'm not sure if that's for better or for worse, but we do see how he's lifting him up in the air, and he will be again, he's not actually doing anything, but
I don't think this matters. It's just pretty annoying, and now Illidan says, I'm sick of that, but there's that force staff, that one coming out from Pilot. He finished it up. They're going to force Illidan in. Bane's gonna nightmare, or excuse me, Abaddon's gonna get himself nightmared up. Eternal Envy, meanwhile, hiding in the trees over here on this off lane. Everyone pushed back into the base on the side of Cloud9, not wanting to give any pickoffs. Gonna let Eternal Envy try to do his thing, and well, Cloud9's gonna try to win this game. I don't know. I feel like they're trying to lose this game. VP's clearly trying to win.
Oh man, this is absurd. I mean, I think it's been over 10k both ways in the same game for experience.
I don't think has that ever happened in the history of Dota.
I honestly have not seen a graph that went that way. So there is a real possibility.
Look at all the kills that when you pull up the experience graph, it's just like almost a solid line.
Jeez.
Bit of downtime between the 40 to 60 minutes.
There's a negative Vengeance aura on the Morana, I believe. Yeah, Avenge died to Morana, yes. So they want to stay out of the pit, let EE do it with full right-click damage, no negative Vengeance aura for him. They'll keep smoking, they'll keep looking. If they kill off DK Phobos or somebody like that and then go in with the Roche items, that'd be big. But for now, they're just moonlighting it without taking Roche. They just want Phobos, they get it, and it's not going to be a fast enough BOT from the Abaddon. So Phobos will go down here, and we look back at top lane. Illidan, FNG, just chilling out. Looking for that kind of final push in, but when it comes down to a raw base race, there's no way that they would beat out C9 if EE has everything he needs, and they go for the Roche.
All right, back into Roche number... I've lost count. I want to say 7?
I honestly didn't have a good count around 3 or 4.
Neither
so
did I. Let's say a 10. This is the 10th Roche. Aegis and Cheese going to go down. Maybe we're going to find like some sort of Easter egg in this game, like maybe the 10th Aegis or Cheese will look different or something, and no one's ever found out about it before.
Drops a crunchy frog.
Until this game. It releases a new hero.
Wow. That's creative.
That'd be pretty funny. That's why Pit Lord hasn't been released.
Well, we have everybody just waiting, posturing on the high ground. The farm doesn't matter. I mean, again, looking at the current gold, there's almost 16,000 gold just banked on Anti-Mage. There's 4k on so many heroes. It's really just buyback resources at this point. Like, nothing else really matters that much. And, I mean, you could look at potential refresher orbs and theorycraft about where they could go there, but end of the day, it just comes down to positioning. Who has buyback, who doesn't, who's alive, who's not, and in what base they happen to be in.
Boots of travel. That's how many there are this game. Almost 10. And I felt the need to read off all of them. You're welcome.
Okay,
we've
so
also got...
get his refresher in the end, whether or not he gets to use 2 abyssals off of that.
Yeah, I was just about to do the refresher count. Refresher... only 2, actually. I guess there's not so many of the refresher ability heroes. I feel like even...
Poison Nova for maximum damage.
Yeah, I feel like Poison Nova could... I feel like Dagon 2 that you don't use is better
Mag getting veiled, getting hit by everything. But Fanta, a little bit unsure. He'll get the Dagon off this time, but... back to base, he BOTs, and he BKBs, and he'll be okay. Still, there are 2 people without BOTs on Cloud9. There's 1 person without BOTs on every VP Polar, and it's the Vengeful Spirit. And when it comes down to it, there's a lot of Blink Daggers, too. There's 4 Blinks on the side of C9. There are 3 on the side of VP Polar. And then 1 Hex versus 2, C9 having the advantage. So, yeah, it's a crazy fucking game, but... at this point, there's nothing that really digs you out of what the state of affairs. Like, this is I would consider it like the Cold War era, like nuclear missile standoff. Both teams have a crazy amount of potential damage they could unleash in full force, but if they do, they risk it being thrown at them and their base. So right now it is really a full stalemate between the two sides, and just kind of gradually approaching from multiple fronts until a pickoff occurs. Smoke of Deceit status, that would be actually interesting to look at. One in stock in the Dire shop, zero in stock in the Radiant for 3 minutes. And as far as I can tell, none on the Heroes and none on the Courier. So Cheese is actually on the Courier. That's interesting to note.
Yeah, I mean, you're this late in the game, like your supports are getting six slotted. Not quite, but actually Yule's Blink, Medallion, Shred. So you got four cheap slots for the Ventral Spirit. She's not doing too bad. Bone 7 got an MKB. The Moonlight Shadow to initiate and try to find a kill. They're going to go on Phobos right now. He does have buyback right now, so even this is not going to be really ending the game, but it's a start for C9. And now you come in with the mag, the skewer. Pilot Guy's actually going to dodge the skewer, and Anti-Mage is going to jump straight onto him right now. Bone 7 is going to do what he can, but Illidan's just going to kill everybody. Envy just running straight in for the throne, but there's still a glyph. And there's people here. Okay, actually, Feta and Jakiro and Lycan are all here. Everyone's got to run back.
Lil's dead.
Anti-Mage is here, though, and they're not going to be able to do anything about it. He's probably going to kill Feta as well. He'll get Yulzed up here. I think that's AUI throwing up in the air, maybe an Ice Path as well. But Illidan is just running after him, and he's going to bring him down. He's unstoppable, and C9, they just can't get onto that Ancient whatsoever. They'd even have to use the Glyph right there.
Yeah. It's also, as far as those that didn't catch it, the Magnus, he blink forced, then refreshed to blink back in. And while that's really cool, having two RPs versus one that didn't even save the Brewmaster, it definitely wasn't what they needed there. The Brewmaster still dies, and just getting there a moment faster doesn't really change the state of affairs. So the
Brewmaster with buyback as well.
Yeah, that's the thing. Like, his buyback, his second life was the important one, not the first. And yeah, the Brewmaster, the Magnus going for that. Yes, he got in there quick, but I think it was a mistake to use the Refresher that way. In either case, they've taken down two. They want to force at least one to buy back, so Illidan's on the front lines here, destroying these Mega Creeps so very quickly. But he's about to break 20,000 gold.
Yeah, 20k current gold, 55,000 net worth, 1,300 last hits. Tower's going down. Cloud9, I mean, they're not going to get any stronger. Like, they can't do anything. Unless Virtus Pro screw up at this point, like, Cloud9's not going to hit the throne. And I don't know, like, you would think the team with that is going up against an undefended Ancient would have the advantage here, but VP Polar has stuck in it to win it since, like, the 40-minute mark, and they've just been climbing steadily.
Yeah, I think it's pretty huge that Lycan has not picked up AC yet. He's actually going to go for... He hasn't had an Abyssal this whole time.
His items are useless, honestly. Okay, useless is over-exaggerating, but, like, you look at a Lycan with these items, like, a Blink... He has a Blink, Deso, BKB, MKB, like...
I think it's fine. It's not, like, it's not, like, game-ending, but,
did he have,
like,
a Necro Book at any point during this game? He didn't go for it, right?
Yeah, he did have Necro Book.
And he sold it?
Yes.
I mean, I guess Anti-Mage just kills it, but when you're pushing by yourself like that, I mean, at least drop him. Probably
nice
could have got a rack.
There's the Fiends, though. Do you need FNG out of the fight first? He wants to blink and Fiends onto the Anti-Mage. He gets a Fodic and he gets out.
FNG still trying to run. Borrowing all that time. He's got the gem. Now the RP comes through. That's onto Eternal Envy, but there's no second RP. Not for another 15 seconds. Illidan could be in danger of going down right now. Let's see if he's got the buyback. He does have a buyback. Three people up on the cliff, all chasing Mag. I think they all blinked up there too. Mag is in some trouble. Buyback on all three of the heroes that just go down. Boots of traveling up to the top lane almost immediately.
So, going back to your talk about useless items, like, that's how they killed Anti-Mage, is by...
No, I don't think they're useless, but, like, he can't kill Anti-Mage with them now, and I don't know. I don't think he ever had Necro, by the way.
He just, with the MKB, Basher, and Dezo, kills Anti-Mage. Like, Anti-Mage is not really good at 1v1 by comparison, and this Lycan has 1.5 base attack time.
Real point was that he wasn't even, like... hardly six slotted. Like, he's bought and sold so many items.
Yeah,
he was sitting with
that.
Four items. You look at Anti-Mage, 20,000 gold with a freaking Butterfly, Manta, Abyssal Blade, Heart, like, all the right items.
You know, I definitely agree he wasn't six slotted, but it's not, he could still do enough with what he had. And he still had room for progression as well, which is all good. Eternal Envy going in with the shapeshift, blinking right onto TK Phobos. Huge kill if they can pull that off. He does get bashed, but he gets a split, and this is a lot of time wasted for EE. They're backing off, forced two buybacks, one on Mag, one on Abaddon. But end of the day, the game is still afoot. Actually, buyback on Anti-Mage as well, but he's taking it like a trooper. Enfeeble doesn't even take his green numbers down very low at all, as he just clobbers these creep waves and keeps his Ancient full.
Yeah, it is actually almost all the way back to full health. There's a ton of creeps in his base, but Cloud9 still can't even take a fight. I don't even know, man. This game is beyond ridiculous.
I don't know, one arrow could do it though. Like, at the same time, like, if you make sure that you kill the creep that FNG is BOTing to, Anti-Mage out here like this.
There's that arrow! Bone 7 actually does a lot, but I think the blink will be here, yeah.
Yeah, no, it has to be a 2v1 situation. But in that situation, like, it would be insane. That's why I was calling out, because I saw Bone 7 moving, but I was expecting a BOT. I was expecting maybe Lycan to jump in or something, but it doesn't happen. He still doesn't have that Abyssal Blade and still has to save for his buyback, right? Yeah, he still has it. And his unreliable gold count is 3,500, so, and that means only 1,263 is reliable.
All right, moving on across the map. Why is he still farming? Can you tell me? Why is Illidan, like, he could just stand still?
That's big numbers.
I mean, obviously you want to push the waves, but Ancients, yes, really?
I know, I called it earlier. The farming Ancients is not his job. It's fun to have the big numbers. I mean, he's probably over 1,000 last hits.
That's
almost 1,400 last hits. It's fun to have those big numbers, but all in all, if it's non-neutral creeps, he should be pushing out the waves. If it's neutral creeps, he should be letting allies farm to get six slotted, since obviously he's well beyond that territory.
If anyone's like, just joining
us, there's no Lincoln Spears this game, which is pathetic. This is a 91-minute game. Everybody could be getting a Lincoln to put on their big carries, but not a single one.
Yeah,
has.
I'm really surprised. I would have liked to have seen Feta go for one when he was sitting on like 6k gold and then decided to buy a Dagon that he didn't use.
Dude, it's one time.
I don't like it, man. It could have been the freaking game. One time with the throne exposed for the last 40 minutes could have been the game. Sloppy ass play, man.
Dagon's fine.
Like, they should have won this game 50 minutes ago.
I honestly think VP Polar, they held their high ground well. I mean, they
I think they did too, but
then stop flaming and just appreciate this fucking amazing game on our hands. Like, this is as tense as it gets. Like, I've often talked about the risk reward of hyper late game Dota, but this goes even beyond that.
Yeah, like, it really does. This is like untheory craftable. Like, there's so many variables. Well, actually, a lot of buybacks are limited right now, so we've limited them. None on Magnus for 5, none on Abaddon for 5, 4 minutes on Anti-Mage, 2 minutes about on the Brewmaster, not enough money on the poor, poor Vengeful Spirit. I feel bad for the supports in this game. Vengeful Spirit's probably having the most fun. He's made so many big plays with this Nether Swap throughout the 91 minutes of this game, more so in the later hour of it, but...
No, it's huge. It absolutely is. And until Bane picks up a Lincoln Sphere himself, he can always just consider it a get out of Fiend's Grip free card if the Aphotic Shield isn't available. But that's a pretty big cooldown. 6 seconds. Do you think there's a way to kill the Abaddon here? Like, obviously he doesn't have buyback, so he was killed very recently. But is there a way to actually, like, in a, like, not full 5v5, but let's say a 3v3 or something where it breaks out on the sidelines, is there a way... Totally without Venom.
Yeah, I mean, you
go through the borrowed time, wait it out.
Upgrade your Dagon and freaking kill him.
And actually kill him. Because if they take out FNG, the Illidan actually becomes relatively easy to bring down.
400 is the threshold.
Backline, like, they're all BOTing to the wolves! His wolves!
Oh, I hear they're pretty good. BOTing straight into the warm embrace of the Magnus, the double RP, the spirits are here, Illidan's there, but a beautiful ice path coming out from AUI, gonna keep him alive, no one has actually died yet. Illidan full HP, Eternal Envy pretty low, Bone 7 running away, Aoi gonna be chased up, he's the one that kept his team alive, he'll get abyssaled, he's still ghost sceptered for the time being, trying to run away, buying space. Creeps pushing into the bottom lane right now, the Megas, Feta's gonna fall, he's no longer having any more fun.
Arid of Shadows is fucking broken, dude. That's like the one of the 6 slot items you should have.
I mean, your support. I feel like if you don't have an urn in a game of Dota, like, your team has played so incorrectly.
But it just the canceling the blink dagger there, like, it's getting so many kills. This is the third time that somebody has died because they can't blink because of urn. It's so good. But anyways, I love that play from Cloud9. This cheeky triple BOT to Invisible Wolf Strat, just suddenly the entire team onto DK Phobos. It was so smart, but Mag was there with the quick reverse polarity and times two. They didn't actually get that much damage from the anti-mage because first he wasn't empowered, and then when he got in, a great ice path and hex coming out from Aoi 2000. So they do keep Illidan out and keep them from being wiped, but that literally could have been the game right there. This is so intense.
I think a lot of things could have been the game right there. 66-53. Let's take another look at the glorious avant-garde gold graph. Yeah, actually, I think the experience one is even more ridiculous. Going down from what 12,000 to 11,000.
Graph of that magnitude.
Yeah, I don't think so. We got a lot of people watching right now. Anyone seen anything like that? Type yes in Twitch chat if you've seen a graph that goes to 10,000 on both ends. Meanwhile, Manta Illusions bringing down some racks. Goku working on that. He needs to power up, dude. He needs to hit Super Saiyan 3.
More.
This has been the length of like 5 Dragon Ball Z episodes. How has he not charged the Spirit Bomb? Like,
seriously.
Answer me that question.
Twitch chat, we need more Spirit Bomb. What the fuck are you guys doing? Holy crap, this game is insane. I'm just trying to think of like where's the next piece of the puzzle? The Geometry Sight Vision, like if we look at Observer Wards, it's just kind of spread intermittently. There's one in mid lane, there's one on top lane, seeing the split push, seeing the rat plays. Illidan will be caught inside the Nightmare first and foremost, FNG taking that off immediately. They need to get dual disables out. They need Hex Arrows and they need Nightmare Fiend Scripts. Like, they need to make sure that these are all covered up so that FNG can't shield the AM and they can just kill him in the duration of one of those.
Eternal Envy is getting pretty close to the buyback with the Abyssal Blade. He goes towards the Secret Shop now. He won't quite buy it. But the Blink Abyssal Blade, it was the answer in the last game, which was almost 2 hours ago at this point.
Oh, God. Don't even remind me of that fact.
We saw it. It was Sven with the Blink, Stormhammer, Abyssal, and it was also Broodmother with the Blink and Abyssal Blade. It was what got them the victory. That was even 2 games ago. So probably
the
more
Sven
than
didn't have a blink, but you're absolutely correct.
Yeah, whatever. I mean, Abyssal Blades are
probably
good.
Let me go down bottom.
Phobos. Going to be sheeped up. Another good swap. Another good ice path as well by AUI to hold him in place. The Boots of Travel coming in. Not going to allow it, but Mag gets in anyways. TPing in the nick of time. Spirit Bomb is going to get RP'd up by Mag once more. The Shockwave will miss, but it doesn't matter. Another RP here. Another Shockwave to throw out afterwards. The Refresher. EE goes down. Buyback on them both. Down for 100 seconds, but I'm sure that buyback will be forced. Meanwhile, Anti-Mage wasn't even in that fight. He's pushing out the creep waves. Team fight not done yet. Feta is going to jump in. Pylai die as well. Who do they bring down? They brought down the Venge. And here's the buyback. Lycan now in here, into the fray. 20 seconds on his shapeshift, but they will bring down Phobos with a nice Fiend's Grip. Morana focuses on that damage, brings him down. It's now 68-55. Okay. Buyback on Brew, but there is no Vengeful Spirit.
Yeah, she's emanating the Vengeance Aura to Morana. Bone 7 for 80 seconds is going to give them that negative 36 damage.
I'll
so that's a
top.
Pretty big deal. Just get out of here. Do something else. We want to push. But Fata actually pinned in Bag in the corner there, but he doesn't have a way to cancel TPs. With the Hex on cooldown, he actually doesn't have anything. And I think that's actually huge. He needs maybe a Yule's. I don't know. Maybe a refresher.
There needs to be more refreshers.
Really, but I don't know. I mean, obviously, like the Dagon 2, I don't mind it because I think that there is a lot of value in just quickly taking somebody out before maybe an Abaddon can save their life or something. But end of the day, we still need. And it's good for Lincoln's popping too. But in the end, we need more ways to cancel TPs because people are disengaging too effectively. Still, you could definitely see how C9 wanted to play that last fight. They started engaging and they had the EE buyback. They wanted to use it offensively, and in doing so, they take the Roshan. But what do they do with the Aegis and the cheese? Before it went to Eternal Envy, but he's starting to flesh out his item slots. So he picks up the cheese. Is that his blink dagger on the ground? Oh my god.
Yeah, it is actually. He's had 12 different items throughout this game. Like, I don't know, it's funny, but he's finally getting close to it.
The cheese, and he's gonna pick up the Aegis. Oh my gosh.
Good thing it wasn't sniped. Look at all these TPs. There's like a trail of TPs. Like, ooh, a TP. Piece of candy. A piece of. Oh no, Lycan.
Aegis? Okay, so Pylodide picks up the Aegis and EE gets his blink back. I was gonna be surprised if he left it there. It's just so clutch to being able to jump in.
Yeah, the blink seems better.
With your full potential. It's also really important for breaking the throne because they have to catch him off guard. Nice ward up here. We didn't really get to talk about it, but at the bottom of the map, there is a ward on the high ground that won't be dewarded easily. Very important when there's a lot of well, no more Necros, but there are gems and stuff flying about.
I'm still not convinced there ever was a Necro, because he went Medallion into... I guess he must have had one. I don't even know. Can't remember at this point. Theta, gonna get jumped on, brought down rather quickly. That's the Abyssal Blade from Illidan getting it. Wow. Illidan is 31-9. Almost half of his team's kills, and they've almost got 70 kills. Saying something. And he got off to a slow start, too. Back to the buybacks. It's really the only thing that matters. Yes, chat, we realize the graph doesn't matter. We just think it's crazy. Anyways, buyback on the Antimage. Buyback on the Magnus. Buyback on the Brew. Morana. Bane. Venno. And Jakiro. Throne. Still sitting at almost 100% HP. The middle
rune. GG rune. A double damage rune. Bottle that shit now. Just get a bottle out here at 98 minutes and get that double damage rune. That is glorious. He's just gonna pick it up. That's fine too. At least it's not in the enemy's hands, but it's so awesome to bottle that shit up. Unfortunately, Odin is 8,000 slotted with 21.8k gold stashed up here.
This guy could buy another ancient, like...
That's... Guys, rock,
at this point, just get some peons, 20,000 gold, some wisps.
Give me a second. A king in chess.
And build another tree of life. Like, come on.
Fuck.
Put it in the top left this time so the dire don't know where it is. That's the trick.
Yeah. Oh, have you ever had Warcraft 3 played Night Elf and started losing and then you like BM somebody by just uprooting your tree of life
and then moving it?
It has an ability to eat through the tree line, so you just dig a tunnel into the forest and you have to buy flying units to find it.
I didn't play Warcraft 3 very much. Only a couple times against my friends, and we were both very, very bad.
Well...
Had to,
I'm
like,
sure
farm and stuff. It was
he controls, I'm guessing he can't micros wolves.
I mean, is that a game bug, or is that just... This game has been so long, his hands hurt.
No, it bugged. Is bugged. I think it's okay for the teams to get a 60-second breather, even if it is technical or non-technical.
No, of course. Hydration at this point, like... Need some water, man.
I mean, it's a shame we didn't have a Darkseid this game. When the Iron Shell is involved, the... special effects, the meteor showers and the apocalypse and whatever does start happening around 100 minutes into the game.
No, I saw some posts reemerged of that, and they were showing it at like 80 minutes, and I haven't seen any.
Yeah, it's if there's a lot of Iron Shells. Darkseer has...
Oh, okay, I see. I wasn't aware of that was the interaction, so now it all makes sense to me.
It's not. It's just spells in general, but Darkseer is the main perpetrator for that. All right.
That's so rare. That's so weird. Like, how does that even happen?
Happy coincidence. Holy shit, look at Vengeful Spirit's TPs. He doesn't have BOTs, but he's covered.
Yeah, I mean, you don't want to lose 1,600 gold when you're about to die, so you just buy 19 TPs.
Oh, those are owned by Illidan. Antimage bought everybody TPs.
Oh, that's why. Is that why there's like 100 TPs laying all over the place? I think all the Roche Pit TPs are probably C9s, and they've left 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
The thing is, there's only one hero in the game that doesn't have BOTs. He felt bad for Lil. He said, don't worry about buying any more scrolls, and he gave them all the scrolls he could possibly need. I'm sure they could
you
be
think
like,
this anti-mage is buying wards? Because I would hope so.
I would certainly hope so. But yeah, okay, smoke status. There is no smokes on Radiant. There are two smokes on Dire. Couldn't Cloud9 do something with that? I mean, I know they've been using the Moonlight Shadow, the BOT plays, but I feel like something could happen with these smokes. I mean, they're a creative bunch. They could even solo smokes for whatever Aoi's doing down bottom. Does force Mags BKB. It's only a minute cooldown. And yeah, he'll just walk away. Mag, by the way, going for his Hex, but doesn't want to buy out. Oh, midlight, Pylite die, getting abyssaled. He will almost be mana voided down, but he actually gets away, and he does still have an Aegis. Odd enough to say. Now Illidan in the base. Where's Abaddon? He needs to keep him up. Yeah, they just blink out. Now, going to see down bottom. There is going to be an attempted RP, but he gets used up, and he'll be forced back. The Brew split, pretty much worthless as well. But a swap, not going to prevent Aoi from escaping here.
Is this a slipper? Does this Jakiro oil up before this game, or what? Like,
okay,
so slippery.
Okay. Brewmaster, can he blink out? Can he blink out? No, he gets scaled. He doesn't have a blink anymore.
No, he sold the blink, so no, he cannot blink out. Fiend's Grip. Lots of damage. Physical coming in from Bone 7. He BKBs up, gets Fiend's Grip. No Abaddon to save him. He'll be down. But guess what, guys? He's got a buyback.
Yeah, only one really lacking that's of huge importance is the Lycan.
Yeah. Even Abaddon to an extent.
Yeah, I mean, those are important. Don't get anybody in, having buyback in this game is relevant, but the really important ones, they're waiting on buyback from Eternal Envy. 1 minute. And that means, as it stands, he's still not able to pick up an Abyssal Blade, which kind of important. Like, if they had the Abyssal right now, I think they'd be in a game-winning position. Unlike the, you know, past 100 minutes. But we do see Anti-Mage blinking up to the high ground, a little bit dangerous. The Hex will connect, but will they actually be able to bash him down? No, Abaddon's here, dispels it, and they try to turn around. FNG, fine with his borrowed time, even against the Poison Nova, and Fata forcing it out early with that nice Dagon. It's gonna be Bone 7 to bring down the Vengeful Spirit, but Anti-Mage does kill off the Venomancer in turn.
Yeah, Brew not even gonna be forced to do the buyback here as they pick off the Venomancer, so Feta down right now. 70 to 57 into the base. They are, though. This is Moonlight Shadow here from Bone 7 trying to bring down the house, trying to bring down FNG. There is, man, a couple more clicks there, but has to watch out for the bash chance. Abyssal was on cooldown. He maybe could have killed the Abaddon. Again, no buyback on that hero. 1,000 gold short. Eternal Envy pushing in the bottom lane right now. Up top, there's Aoi. He switched up the lanes. 7,000 gold there. 9,000 on Mirana, 6,000 on, and this is current gold, by the way, not net worth. 22K, 10,000, a couple sevens, fives. Even the poorest person in the game has 1,300 gold saved up right now.
Now, reminder that buyback, it has a factor of time as well as levels. So in this case, everybody's buyback is extremely expensive. Like, everybody's level 25, of course, but it's also 2,500 gold to buy back in this game, and that's reliable gold, which is kind of scarce when all the towers are dead and we haven't seen enough kills recently.
100 minute, yeah. Chat's on the spam. We are indeed over 100 minutes. 103, in fact, and we're going to be looking for 9 Roshans? 8 Roshans?
Somebody
has any idea? It's some massive number. I'm sure someone somewhere is keeping track. We'll probably see the information.
Don't you dare take that DD rune, Pilot Eye.
Do it, Pilot Eye.
It's not even cool. Give it to... I mean, Mirana's got pretty good agi game at this stage in the game. 2.75 per level, so at level 25 with this butterfly, she is kind of in carry mode. Not the hardest carry, of course. Doesn't stand up to Anti-Mage or Lycan here, but it's not bad. It certainly is not. Eternal Envy, DBOTing to the mid lane. Big commitment here. The fortification is up on the Radiant Throne, but they're just forcing defensive play so that they can go into DK Phobos easily. And there is no Aphotic Shield. He's going down. A free kill for them, though he will have buyback.
Story of the game. He dies, but he does have buyback.
Note, it's still, I'll say for the next 20
minutes. I'm going to keep saying it too. It's the only thing that matters. Fate is in trouble, but he gets off a good Poison Nova. But again, it's the swap from Little that sets it all up. Another kill there. Fate dies, but he does have buyback.
Where's that Ancient Epiphany?
Where's the Necrophos? That was clearly the pick this game.
21 sentries on Lil, because again, he doesn't need. He appreciates the carry supporting him.
That's what happens in the Ultra Relay game. Who would have thought the carry becomes the support so that the support can become the carry?
It's pro Dota. It's not just that they have a courier and a flying courier purchased 3 minutes into the game. It's the fact that the carries buys the wards.
I'm surprised we don't have a bunch of... If I was in this game or any game going this long, I would have just bought like 100 couriers and put them on follow in an endless circle with shift queues, so they were just running around in a circle on the map for
might disrupt somebody. If it takes one right click away from the ancient, it's worth it.
Yeah, right? Just around. Pipe the pans, man.
All right, so Refresher did come out for Jakiro here. He's got Blink, Force, Hex, Yules, BOTs. Alright. You can go double Macropyre, some more Ice Paths. Like, you can't TP away from him.
How is this Dagon only level 3? Like, what?
Fanta's died 17
I'm
times.
I'm really upset.
He's died 17
times. Dagon. It's my only quarrel with this entire game is that Dagon and the fact that he didn't use it that one time.
Like, 40 minutes ago, at
yes.
least.
PJ Salt, dude.
And it still probably didn't even net the kill. Like, I don't
it
know.
It would have. He lived with like one HP.
I don't think so. He had BKB.
That's true. Yeah, might not have done the burst. Whatever.
Alright, so when's Rush respawn?
I don't know, man. Let's look. We should just cover the camera there.
A minute and a half.
Yeah, not too much longer there.
Oh, this is a
beautiful
game.
Guess the HP. Do you think Rosh is going to be at 20k?
18,000 sounds about right.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to quite get the 20 yet, but he might. This game has been stalemated for since, I don't know, dude, like honestly, like 40 minutes in, definitely at 50. So for
about 50 minutes. This is where it starts.
Oh, yeah. Who cares if your base damage is low if you're buying rapiers? That's the way to turn Marana into the Garry.
Yeah, and then we got to see staffed rapiers for the second life when they come back into it. Like, yeah, I don't know. I think it's really hard to call who's does. Okay, Pilot Eye was on the high ground here, but Mag didn't have detection against him, so he survived.
That's a big problem this game.
Okay, let's just top lane. There is going to be a Hex coming out, but this is weird from Fata. This could be him just dying for nothing.
Oh, well. He does have buyback.
Yeah, but still.
I thought you wanted to use it.
To be there. And Hex comes out for Illidan, since he does have a refresher in base. He can use that twice, maybe once. What did he sell, though? He sold the heart. So he only has 2,000 HP, but he does have two lives. Yeah. Interesting decision.
Roche is back in like 10 seconds. Get the HP here.
Yeah, but it's probably going to be support Aegis again. Like, I don't see why they would give it to one of the two cores.
I want to see, like, Venno's dead, forces buyback by... I guess you can't leave your base. Yeah, never mind. Polar really can't. I guess Anti-Mage can go solo it, but he's
Anytime
really...
Anytime backdoor protection is down, they have to have three people in the base and everybody else ready to TP.
That Roche clock just looked so sick for a second. Like, everything disappeared but the circle. That was weird. Anyways, Roche is back. HP is 20,500.
Pretty swell.
I was wrong. I said I didn't think it would be 20k.
Yeah, but there you go.
I don't know. Do you think Roche at this point?
No knowledge of Dota. I have that's a page torn out. I have no idea how Roche scales.
Yeah, neither do I.
This change.
Do you think Roche has buyback?
If only.
I mean, from the time that this game, he's only got 8 deaths. I mean, over time, he's probably got like 10k saved up. I'm sure. How expensive could his buyback be? Where would he buy back?
Fada is tweeting while he's dead. So, because Buenomancer just, he can't survive. Oh my god.
Obviously the feeds are intentional, so he can just use Twitter. Like, oh, I'm dead, guys. Gotta minimize. Nightmare.
Alright, we do see Lil getting
this is a big kill. This Ven just caused them a lot of problems, to be honest. But Mag, again, it's just a space. He can skewer this and maybe get another RP. Oh no, that was actually his second one. He had already refreshed it. There's the BKB now coming up. Lycan's gonna run in here, but Illidan shows up. There's the Hex. Lycan's so speedy, gonna run away. And FNG and Illidan standing together, can anything even stop them? Remember, don't forget the Rapier. If Bone7 dies here, this is all gonna be for nothing. He's down. Divine Rapier on the deck right now, getting pinged out by the support. The Venge probably calling the shots from the grave. Feta abyssaled up. He's getting prepped to send some more tweets. He's about to be sent to the grave. And they're going to let him go. Or the Nightmare there from the Bane is going to keep Illidan a little slow. And they'll only get one kill on the Morana. But guess what?
The Rapier's still on the ground. They didn't see it.
No, they pinged it. Venge was pinging it. They just don't have the slots, or they forgot about it, or what?
I don't know who was
what?
Pinged. Pilot Eye!
What is going on? It was pinged out.
Yeah,
look,
you're right.
Allies, Venge, Divine Rapier dropped here. Yeah. Certainly they're on TeamSpeak or something, screaming at each other.
I don't know. Maybe it's just heat of the moment. They're like talking about the next thing. But either way, I would put it on the Abaddon in this situation, by the way. Give him some right click. He has the borrow time, so he's not going to feed it away immediately. And the Anti-Mage, I don't think it's an ideal slot for him compared to what he currently has. But, you know, it's hard to call. Either way, it's still in the hands of Cloud9. That's a pretty big deal. Up top, it is going to be the jump initiation. Whoa! Owie. Going just too far in. And the big deal here is this Observer Ward on the high ground to the west of it. They can see him. They can jump him. They can find the opening. And he won't be able to do his quick trigger finger blink when they already have him pretty much in their reticule.
Never in my life would I have dreamt of saying the 110-minute Vladimir's on Abaddon has been completed, along with the 110-minute Assault Curious on Lycan. I think it's just a little late from their average timings, but I'm not positive. We don't have a stats, man.
Look at the fucking experience graph right now. It is zero.
The chat's gonna rage if I open that graph again. Meanwhile, Pilidae. Dying.
I guess would it always go to zero because of how like level how experience works?
Yeah, because everyone hits 25, right? It has to even out eventually.
Okay, I didn't even think about that. I don't think I've ever seen a 10 level 25 hero game, honestly.
Yeah, so it's flat.
Bottom
at zero.
Lane, Eternal Envy, jumping in, blink out from Lil. They don't want to kill Lil. The aura actually hurts them here. But
he used Dagon, I'm proud.
If he doesn't get to defensively swap, that's great. Top lane, they pop the fortification on their racks, they arrow, and it does connect onto Illidan. But can they kill him with the rapier? Almost! Look at the crits!
Woo! Imagine if Polar had picked up that rapier. When they watch this replay, if they even bother, since it's so long, and it's probably a gigabyte at this point.
Oh, bottom. They're just going in. Pops the split.
This is a fast little sheep, man. He's been running around a lot. He turns back around to get some right clicks. Could this be the end? Pilei Dai is going to die up top. No buyback there. AUI respawning fist. They're actually, this is the first time everyone's been hitting the Ancient in a long time, if not the first time. Down. Magnus is going to go down. He's got the buyback available right now.
They force or they back out with Flutter. Big. He's got his refresh assumed, but not the standard RP.
And they're going to hold on.
Is Antimage killing off the Venomancer? I don't know why he's stuck around to right-click the Ancient a few more times. It's going to regen anyways, but it is what it is. Buenomancer down, boys.
No bueno. C bueno for VP Polar. No bueno for C9.
So the experience graph is just going to be literally zero for the rest of the game. The gold graph,
yeah.
Again,
I wasn't sure if like they'd still get experience and it would just go past 25. I always actually wondered that. So we've got our answer.
Experience per minute is going down constantly, right? Like if you look at the chart.
Yeah. Well, I've never seen that before. Like,
you know what? I agree with you. It's actually an interesting thought experiment. Like you can probably do it in a bots game, but I've just never bothered.
I didn't think they would have bothered. I guess the programming just worked out to where, you know, it just fills up and then no one gets anymore. But yeah, everyone down to, you know, Anti-Mage with 290 experience per minute just carrying this game.
I actually don't like the fact that it keeps going down because I think that...
Yeah, you lose kind of some information there.
It should go at level 25, what your experience per minute has been up to that point, and you should freeze it. EE under the Observer Ward at Legendary...
I think this game, will, and our cast will get that change into the game.
Nice. Reddit.
Reddit.
You're on it.
Do it. Oh, Missile Blade does not want to kill the Venge. We'll lose so much damage. 5,200 gold, so you know he's got buyback.
That's the more important thing. More than anything else, Illidan gets the Abyssal Blade off! EE going down!
Wow, big Mana Void. Guess what? Buyback.
Of course, but... I guess we should say when they don't have buyback. Let's just shut up about them having buyback and say they don't have buyback.
Oh, but that's more fun. Alright, fine. I can agree to that. Bane respawns. He did not have buyback.
Okay, so in the base there's a BKB chilling. I guess that... I don't know. This game is so scrambled in my head. I don't know who has
I don't even, like, remember the lanes.
I guess
I'm going to be honest. Alright, Anti-Mage is going to find out AUI, the Slippery Jakiro. Mag is here. Not going to use the RP for that. The Shockwave will do it. I want to look at the kills real quick. 38 on Anti-Mage, 16. And they're pushing up the middle lane right now.
Force two buybacks here. That's pretty huge.
Roche is up, by the way.
Oh.
No one's gone for the 21,500 HP Roche.
Yeah, so... 18 armor hits for over 350, and there's a second Divine Rapier. Are they both on the same, though? Is he slotting one? Yeah, I think he's stashing one.
Yeah, I mean, why not? I feel like Anti-Mage should just have a whole stash filled with... Like, how baller is that? To say you played in a official match and had a stash full of rapiers? Because Anti-Mage could do it and, like, still have back.
His current gold is pretty baller.
Although he is a support now, so I guess he's buying wards.
All the wards. Two smokes on Radiant as well. Apparently, the pros aren't as fond of 114-minute smokes as I thought they might be. So I obviously haven't really experienced it. I've seen smoke ganks that win 80-minute games, but not so much in the 114s. So maybe they're...
I think anyone's too scared to take that high risk right now. Like, it's gone this long. Like, think of the time
investment.
At the very
least, it's a movement speed boost. You can just get from the courier.
Yeah, I guess that's true, too.
Just solo smoke somebody and move across the map faster. Either way, we got 1-7 trying to BOT out.
This is a rapier. They're going to have to know about this one. Please.
Who gets
for all that is holy, pick it up. Vengeful Spirit is now a carry.
1-7 still has one rapier.
Anti-Mage did his job as a support. He supported long enough that Vengeful Spirit has now become a carry.
Suddenly.
That is true meta.
Power doesn't enhance this item, but I guess that would be pretty OP. All right. The smokes are purchased. Onto the courier. Of a Cloud9, Dusky the Husky. Look at the base! Look at the Dire base! Gem.
That's not the Dire. I am drunk. I need to go home.
Yeah. So they're going to go for a smoke plus Moonlight Shadow. They're going in. Good flank here. They have to get the Abaddon down. Or Hex the Abaddon, Nightmare the Abaddon.
They've done it! But Illidan has not died in that time. There's also the defensive play, but you got to be careful jumping in as little. You've got the rapier. They're going to kill Bone7 again. Did he pick up the other rapier? Is it on the ground? I can't even tell. There's too much going on. Yeah, it is down in the trees. Mag was purple as well. Couldn't quite tell. Meanwhile, double kill. He will bring down the Anti-Mage, but Anti-Mage bought back. No, boots of Travel right in, still fighting. The bashes. The Mana Void's going to do it. The Lycan is dead again. He does have buyback. Morana does it and just fed two Rapiers right now.
Yeah, so who are those on right now? Like, what the fuck?
Cloud,
nobody has Rapiers.
Cloud 7.
I think they just left them. Like, there's one in the trees. Oh my gosh.
Wait, where's Venge? He doesn't even have his either. They don't want to give them back, I guess is the thing.
Yeah, so just die somewhere. Oh yeah, it's over here. Okay, so we got two Rapiers on the ground. Not irrelevant to this game at all. Fatu goes for a Gale play, misses it. Doesn't have a Force Staff to get out, but they're not worried about it at all. So we see Illidan
from the trees! The flank onto Illidan, but Illidan's doing way
If they kill
more.
Lycan, they win the game, period.
Yeah, they definitely do. There is no buyback on Lycan for another 6.5 minutes. Feta getting it off the Poison Nova.
5 wins of Mega Creeps.
Yeah, that's all little. He should have kept the Rapier, man.
He's dead. He died. Whatever. FNG. There's a bash onto Fanta. They missile him up. He's going down. He will come back in just a moment. This is down to the last moment. Will it kill the no buyback Anti-Mage, or will they kill the no buyback Lycan? For now, it's Abaddon to fall, and everybody is back to a stalemate. Fucking Dota 2.
At what point do we just call it a draw? No points. Do we know what the longest game, competitive game?
It would have been the TR3 game between, I believe, DKIG? No, it was IG and...
No idea, but I would assume a Chinese team was in it, especially yes, back in TI3.
It was maybe old DKIG.
Yeah, I think that sounds right. What was it? 100? I thought it was like 109 or something.
136 or something like that.
Oh, 136. Okay, just kidding. Way longer. It was 2 hours and like maybe 6 or 9 minutes. All right. Well, this has the potential to break the record. That's for sure. Definitely, this is just a BO1 group stage match. There is not millions of dollars on the line here. And look at that, Squawkins, Lieutenant Squawkins. Did he not see it? He was floating right above. And that was actually the Radiant Courier looking for that Divine Rapier. Couldn't find it. Now, Little Hardy.
Pick it up.
Okay, so they've got that Rapier back. The other one is still, it was down here. Did Morana go and, Morana got hers back as well. I don't know why they didn't scramble a Courier in the middle of that team fight.
And I cannot pick it up. The heroes have to, I think. I don't fucking play with Divine Rapiers.
Yeah, dude, I honestly, we're gonna get flamed so hard, or at least I will. I don't know. I don't think couriers can pick
it
up. So.
Blink away, fucking distracting them all game long.
Yeah, that's definitely it. They can't pick it up. But everyone's got so many other big items, they don't really want to drop it. I feel like Little could have maybe picked up both of them. Like, drop this Medallion of Courage. Armor's nice, but taking away both the Divine Rapiers is probably better. Roche goes down, and it doesn't take long.
But I got to the chance, we had plenty of time, so I googled the longest game. TI3 had DK versus IG at 98 minutes. The other longest game is actually 125. So we're only 7 minutes away. That was 34 weeks ago. I don't think anything popped up in between them. But that was, looks like 4FC versus, First Departure versus... I don't know. Fuck it. I'm not reading an article while we're casting code.
Please, read it to us.
There was a game in 125 minutes. Let's go. 6 more minutes, guys.
6 more minutes. At this point, we might as well finish it out. The long run. So I can at least say I've done something in my life. I've casted the longest competitive Dota game in history, potentially. Probably did a shit job.
Scouting for Eternal Envy, maybe and creating more opportunities to BOT forward. But I think obviously any team would be in chaos right now. Even the most composed competitive team would be like, okay, what the fuck do we do? We have buybacks. Did we track Anti-Mage's buyback? Did we track so-and-so's buyback? Like, it's so hard to keep up with all the numbers, the Roche timer, everything that is relevant at this stage in the game. And so, although mechanically they can't be like really doing that much, they're killing up a couple neutral camps. The strategy, like racking your brain to find an answer, is really what it is. This has come down to the last
couple
moves
you wanted to see,
and we're gonna see them try to put those forward. They're looking for checkmate. Backdoor protection will be down with the next wave, but I think they want to go for hero kills. They Moonlight Shadow forward. They're going to find Lil and DK Phobos. DK Phobos being the big kill.
Yeah, DK Phobos, one of the few heroes that actually still has buyback right now. Everyone's dwindling. Probably why everyone was starting to play so safe. He'll die. He'll buy back. Mag just whiffs an RP entirely. He'll have another one. He's going to refresh up here. He just whiffed two in a row. What is he doing? Bone 7, though, will still fall. Another Rapier on the ground. Look back at the base. Half HP. Little, he's got to go. He can still bring these down. They're just creeps. Eternal Envy is here. Can this be the end? Illidan is going to jump on. Eternal Envy, if he dies, this is going to be the game. There's no buyback for 2 minutes right now.
Holy shit, that just happened. Like, they went for the all-in on the throat,
oh my God.
And now
I feel so bad for Mag.
without Eternal Envy. Oh, Illidan's just going to go right at the mid lane. I mean, at this point, without Bone 7 being able to buy back, without Eternal Envy being able to buy back, all they can do is rat. All they can do is try to keep them on the defensive and they're on base, but Hour 2000, he gets caught out when doing so, and they do get the Yules. This is going to be him going down unless he blinks it. Oh, it's his Yules. What the heck? This ward again! The OP clip ward! Envy fucking P ward! Owie can't rat it, which means they have the sands ticking down in the hourglass. 44 seconds left to get a right clicker on the table. And yeah. I mean, this is going to be VP Polar's chance. They have 40 seconds to get into the base, and even then, they only have to face the Mirana without any divines, as far as I can see. Yeah, no divines.
Yeah, she's
no
dropped like five divines.
Oh, there's one. There's one in the base. Somebody picked it up.
What? How? Look at all the gems. This is the most colorful base. Are they decorating for Christmas? Is that what this game's all about?
This is too epic to make Christmas jokes, okay?
Oh, come on. That was a good joke.
Refresher orb here.
Tactical.
Like, this fucking game. Bane is having some lag issues here. Wait, what? Okay, mid. So they jumped in, they BOT'd and blinked forward here for the jump onto Fata. Fata is abyssaled right now with nobody having any hope of saving him. He was trying to get some plague wards down, I'm pretty sure, for the counter
brain
push.
Lag. I also have some brain lag.
That's why I'm trying to carry you, man. I can tell you're tired.
Usual for me. Got the brain lag. Yeah. Let's take another look at the glorious items. There's a bunch, and to be honest, they haven't changed all that much except for the spotting of the rapiers. Little, obviously, still holding onto his. And yeah, actually, it hasn't changed at all. Everyone's been six-slotted for so long.
Yeah, well, kind of. I mean, like, Venge is a divine rapier, blink.
We finally got the Dagon 5. No, it's still the Dagon 3.
Yeah, well, I mean, he's died.
Yeah, he's actually died so many times.
So, while we wait for Fata to die after the unpause, because he has abyssaled in mid lane, let's talk about some crazy numbers. We've got 2,053 last hits for Anti-Mage.
That's got to be a record,
42
right?
42 kills, 23 assists. He has 805 GPM in this 121-minute game, totaling up for 33,000 bank gold. He's about to have half of his net worth in his bank. I don't fucking know.
Anti-Mage is ready for retirement. Nice nest egg in this game.
Net worth is flowing 20,000 gold in favor of Virtus Pro Polar, but they still have heroes with like three vacant slots, I feel like. The Treads, the TP Scroll, maybe not the Yules. Yules is awesome, but it's just like there are so many like very like 2,000 gold-ish items on Lil and on FNG. And yeah. I don't fucking know. I mean, ideally, everybody would have, like, a Blink Refresher, Scythe, Abyssal, and then they would be able to win the game off of that. Also, some fucking Liquid Spheres. I can't help but go back to that.
Yeah, I was requesting that before it was cool. Everyone, we've been sitting at the computer for a long time, so if you'd like to get with me, if you'd like to stand up, we can do some stretching. Oh, maybe some calisthenics. Gotta stay in shape. You don't want to get restless leg syndrome or something. Do some stretching. Get that back. Work it up and down.
I just believe that this game, having come to this level, we look at one of the most important skills in this entire game, reverse polarity. We just saw it whiff twice in a row. As well as several ones where he screws up. He does a refresher first and then the RP. And yet they're still dominating this game right now at this moment. Yes, the Mega Creeps are a minor setback, but in the end, the Anti-Mage just can't be stopped.
I mean, lowest the Ancient's been, though? 1,000 HP?
It's been pretty well covered, yeah. They have Fortification, that's the big thing. Like, it could have 5 HP. Okay, no. It can have... Whatever.
I mean, it can have 5 HP, but it's probably not a good sign for Polar.
Alright, so no Roach Forever. Probably not for the rest of this game. I don't even think we can break the 125 with the current state of
the game. I don't think we're going to do it. I'm pretty upset. By the way, our creeps. Almost as your mega creeps. Oh, yeah, oh my god, because they're still scaling?
The level up factor of mega creeps is very interesting. 710. Okay, so essentially, yeah, these super melee creeps have been out for so long, and as like every 7.5 minutes or something, they get an extra level. That to a point, at a certain point, they are as strong as the mega melee creeps.
At like 3 hours, your creeps are stronger.
Yeah, like I don't. Yeah, I guess they cap out. I thought there was like a both of them cap out system, but apparently they can't even override.
So better to give up.
Oh my gosh. So 15 seconds on Bone 7 without any rapiers. Eternal Envy down for 50 seconds, period. Yeah, I thought that like they go up to 30 and then cap out there at equal levels, but fuck if I know. Yeah, I mean, this has been an absolutely absurd game of Dota 2, and we're still here. I mean, we've got, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Gems of Truth Sight in the Dire base. We got TP scrolls everywhere, BKB refresher from the anti-mage, just kind of chilling. But he doesn't need it. Actually, there would be a cool tactic, now that I think about it, of putting it on in your stash so that you can grab it from the enemy fountain, if you need to. To, like, refresh your BOTs to jump back, or to get another Abyssal off or something, or his Hex in many cases. Yeah, he initiated with Hex onto Fata, then he followed it up with Abyssal Blade, and they should have the right clicks to finish off Mr. Buenomancer.
Did we point out the sheep on Anti-Mage?
Yeah, no, I just said it.
All right, that's what I thought. That's what I thought, yeah. And I highlighted it. I was just
He dropped a heart a long time ago for that. That was his switch out, and I would argue that both are really. I guess at the end of the day, if you're disabled as Anti-Mage by Hex, by Abyssal, whatever, and you're not getting bailed out by Abaddon, it doesn't matter if you have a 10,000 HP. You're going to be destroyed. But still, the Hex is the big deal here. It's all about the disables, and nobody has a Defusal to purge it off. That's also interesting to note that Rana didn't go for like a Hex purging Defusal, a stat based one, obviously, because Divine Reaper is a little bit better. As far as four staffs go, there is a four staff on Jakiro, who's down towards the bottom with no BOTs. Yep. And there's a one on Bane, but he is currently disconnected, and I don't think there's any way, even with Blink, that he could...
Yeah, they were talking about the four staffing in all chat, but I don't think it's going to happen. That Venomancer is going to get kind of blown up here. I mean, looking at his armor, he does have... 124, but I don't think it's gonna matter. He's got a Poison Nova, so maybe he puts that on and gets him pretty low. I mean, the heart was dropped, so the HP regen isn't quite there anymore from Anti-Mage. I feel like Cloud9 probably can't deal with Anti-Mage at any HP without the Lycan, but I guess it's really only 15 seconds. Like, if Poison Nova goes off, along with the Veil of Discord, maybe if you can manage to even get the anything off, actually, because the Abyssal was used. I'm trying to click on Feta. Okay, yeah, it's still a pretty fresh stun, so he's going to be trapped up in that for, what is it, 1.4 seconds? Or 2 seconds for the active.
Yeah.
So he's not casting anything.
1.4. Oh, no, yeah, you're right. Okay, I went through the same logic chain.
Yes, we did the exact same. I saw the number, I read it, and then I was like, that's wrong, and then I looked for another number, and then I said that number.
Okay, so at this point in the game, does Brewmaster ever Primal Split?
I would say no. I mean... I feel like
because
that's
he's got an active scepter, right?
Falls off. Yeah, maybe so for the double stomp and the double. If you can get the double drunken haze, like for sure, I guess it's okay. But a lot of BKBs to and even MKBs to mitigate that. So drunken haze, I feel like it's not worth it.
I would say
no, but
drunken haze is worthless against this team pretty much because of the MKBs. And the big thing would be Fire Remnant gets crit and evasion.
Yeah,
but
maybe for the CC of the tornado, like if they're fighting at your ancient, so they're just not hitting it, I guess.
Yes, for a base race, I would pop it, but for a fight, I don't think so.
I would agree.
Unless you're about to die anyways, in which case you might as well.
Then why not?
Because you got to buy back BOT.
Exactly. Actually, you don't. Only Magnus and Abaddon have buybacks right now.
Okay, so according to someone who has no credentials that I know of...
I don't have any credentials either, so...
Most last hits in a match is 1,367.
Woo!
So, if that's true, hell yeah, Anti-Mage. He still hasn't finished farming. He still hasn't come out of the trees. Buff is all hell. He still is looking for that opportunity. But, oh, pile I die, please. I want to get a glass of water.
Why is it paused, dude?
It's game.
Press 1 if shit casters.
Dude, always shit casters.
1. I think I upset PPD earlier. I saw him putting in some chat spam. I'm sorry, PPD. I didn't mean it.
I don't even know at this point. Like, I feel like we've kind of fucking covered these 2 hours pretty well, to be honest.
I feel like we have. Yeah, I won't lie. I was pretty checked out between like 50 and 80 minutes, but ever since 100, I've actually been like more hyped than I have for most of the games today.
Maybe DDoSed. That's awesome. So let us play. Let us end the game.
Let us play, please. It's a record game. Actually, should we all try to tell them to just stop for 5 more minutes so we break the record? At this point, it's more important than the win.
Doesn't factor.
What do you mean?
Only Dota 2 is...
No, I know. That's what I'm saying. Like, when they unpause, just sit for 5 minutes and then play as if the Mirana was dead for 15 seconds and Lycan was dead for 52.
According to Pink, the record for the game is 240 minutes.
What?
But that's the non-competitive one.
That's probably like bot item farmers.
Anyways. Okay, they're talking about it, yeah, and maybe there's.
I think they'll come to the conclusion themselves that they should wait. Dog vs. 4FC wasn't any league, says Attic Vat.
Dog versus 4FC lasted for a total of 125 minutes, 26 seconds. So somebody did bad math on that.
It was like 3+ hours.
Now I get to read this article.
Can you divide Eternal Envy? Maybe you need some more. I think Eternal Envy needs some more energy, guys. Can we spam him some more energy, please?
He's playing his wheels like crazy. Like after 2 hours of doing that.
Yeah, he's like, I thought I was playing Dota. Like I'm not a StarCraft pro for a reason. Micro too hard.
At this point, it kind of feels like World of Warcraft. Like the levels almost seem permanent. You got to go for like raid boss Roshan and get your mythicals.
The end game gear. This noob's only got the raid finder gear. Totally gonna crush him. Although I do need resilience in this case.
LFR Roshan.
That's the second time we've run up a WoW.
Yeah, well, you know, once a game hits 2 hours plus 15 minutes of pause, I feel okay for rambling. Like, at this point, theorycrafting is done. Like, I talked about Wolf BOTs, I talked about refreshers, I talked about fucking Lincoln Sphere, but no.
The one spam very fast. Faster than the speed of light. Oh, that was my question I had for chat the other day. Can Twitch chat go faster than the speed of light? That's what I really want to know. Really? Twitch chat wasn't around when Einstein was, so...
So, in this situation, hypothetically, how long, if all of Cloud9 were in Radiant Base and there was no fortification, how long would it take for them to kill off the backdoor to Ancient? I would say not too long at this stage.
I don't think it would take long at all.
They got the AC Dezo, which is already a ton of negative armor. That's taken 12 away, so that's half the armor away from the Ancient. And then, of course, they've got a lot of right-click coming in from the Howl, coming in from the Lycan and his Wolves and his Shapeshift and his 1.5 BAT. So even with the damage reduction, I'd think that it would still go down very quickly. So at some point in time, you have to say even the creep wave doesn't matter as much as just getting everybody in the base. So it's on VP Bullet to prevent them, to keep them out of the base and to disable them as best they can, hopefully missing zero reverse polarities. Speaking of, it's back up in 13 seconds, but, you know, it is what it is. I actually am curious how valid the thing we were talking about with the Vengeance Aura really is.
I feel like I think it's less pretty minimal valid now.
With the Divine Rapiers, it kind of gets alleviated. Along with that, Abyssal Blade is 100 damage, Desolator 60 damage, 88 damage from MKB. These are all green modifiers. So you're only losing, out of 166 of your base damage, you're only losing 36% of that. So it's not that big for the heroes, but of course it is 100% of the Wolves' damage and of the... Damn it, no Necros. Why don't they have fucking Necros?
I don't know. At this point, you think everyone would have a Necro book. Imagine how much easier the... Rat Dota would have been.
You put the Necronomicon in the stash, and then when you BOT backdoor the enemy base, you pull, you swap your BOTs for the Necronomicon at their fountain.
Or you just have an armor of flying couriers waiting in the tree line.
Well, obviously.
Even better, right?
It just looks cool that way.
It does look a lot cooler, yeah.
To show off your like Platinum Roshas or whatever.
I think it's also time for Cloud9 to buy a lot of couriers and just scramble them around the tier 4 so they can't click on them.
Just panic mode.
I mean, at this point, like, I would just drop sentries, smoke, wards, and everything around the buildings so they're harder to click on. I'm not sure that would make a difference. The buildings are fairly large, but...
If only the Warcraft 3 patrol option existed and you could just...
I'm actually so mad they took that out!
I mean, you could shift queue it, but that would
I know.
Be so... We're fucking... No, wait. We're 5v4? What the fuck? They're microing Bane. The dead people are...
That makes sense.
Dead for 50 seconds. But they figured this might be the game breaker, so...
Yeah, I feel like Cloud9 have fallen here. I don't think Goku
right,
was
go.
Strong enough.
Bata, Abyssal Up, being right-click down. No four staffs for him. He will...
He lives! At least a little bit longer. He can point... I feel like he should throw out the Nova. I don't think it really makes a big difference, but... If you could get them even a little bit lower, but...
The cooldown is shorter than his death timer. He can't buy back. Yeah. So, yeah. But whatever. Anyways, top rack's going to get hit here. No Enfeeble coming out just yet from Pilot Eye. Only the Nightmare trying to keep him off of it. There's the Enfeeble, but still the racks will fall. They will not fortify this. It's very important. They need the fortify for the tier 4s and for the Ancient only. Now we see down bottom, there is going to be Audi 2000 getting stunned up, has his Hex, double, he could refresh out another Macro Pyre, but Mag's got that BKB, they will lock him down, Audi is down for the count, he just bought back. So die back there, we see them,
Dude, that went up forever! They're about to kill Illidan! Bone 7 respawn! He's got sheeped up, he'll go down, another Divine on the ground, GG! And you know Fata was playing that, I feel like he just made the play of the game, unfortunately it's the one that they're going to lose. Off of the throne explodes.
G fucking G. Like, wow. I mean, how to wrap that up? That was a 2-hour game.